accepting this invitation once again. Last time when Prabhu visited, Prabhu gave a short, brief lecture. And many of us, Avinash, Dimple, Didi, and everyone, we got so much inspired, we thought we should have one more Q&A seminar. So considering this, Prabhu was kind enough to accept this. So today we'll have Kirtan, short discourse, and all of you can be open to ask questions to Prabhu.
Hare
Thank
Krishna,
you so much,
Hare, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Where is the speaker for this? Where is it? Hare Krishna. Is it loud enough for everybody? Should I do it in English or Hindi? English is good? English. Everybody is comfortable in English? English, yeah. Hare Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. So when I sing, you all will hear me one line and then you'll repeat after me, okay?
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare, Atyutam Keshavam, Rama Narayanam, Achyutam Keshavam, Ramayanam, Krishna Damodaram, Vasudevam Bhaje, Krishna Damodaram, Vasudevam Bhaje, Sridharam Madhavam, Gopikavallabham, Sridharam Madhavam, Gopikavallabham, Janakinayakam, Ramachandram bhaje, Janaki Nayanam, Ramachandram bhaje, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopal Jaya Jaya
Govinda Jaya Jaya Gopal Jaya Jaya
Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Radha Ramana Hari Govinda Jaya Jaya
Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare
Prabhupada Jaya Prabhupada Prabhupada Srila Prabhupada
Prabhupada Jaya Prabhupada Prabhupada Jaya Prabhupada
Pavan Hari Nam Sankirtan Ki Om Ajnanatimirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshuh Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadara Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare So sound is also connected, no? Sound? Correct? From here you have to put that connected.
It's
for good. Yeah. So we are coming together this evening in fond remembrance of Rajkumar Lalwani ji. We had a program few days ago, and many devotees felt we could also have some question answers today. So in the beginning of the topic, probably about half an hour, 40 minutes, I would like to share something very interesting with you. Which can also give us a clue on what was that made Rajkumar Lalwani ji appreciate Krishna consciousness movement so much. What was that bhakti bhava that he was experiencing and glorifying so much? Why is that so? That will become clear for you when you go through this session. You want a little more volume? Yeah. So, holy land free of hunger and anger. This is actually a translation from one of the shlokas in the Srimad Bhagavatam. I will come to the shloka later. You see, there are two verses, one about the material world, one about the spiritual world. We are living in which world now?
Material,
material world. So we'll begin with material world, then we'll go to spiritual world, okay? अहस्तानि सहस्तानाम् अपदानि चतुष्पदाम् फल्गुनि तत्र महताम् जीवो जीवस्य जीवनम्. You see, here it says, in this material world, ahastane sahastanam, those creatures which don't have hands or legs, like grass for example, they become food for other creatures which have legs and hands, which have hands. Like for example, the chatushpada means the cow. It eats, apadani means the grass. It eats the grass. Similarly, the ahastane means the worms. They don't have hands and legs, but sahastana means the birds. They capture the worms. You can see that. Falguni means weak. Mahata means strong. The weaker ones become food for the stronger ones. And jivo jivasya jivanam is the law of the material world, which means one living being becomes a food for another. That's the meaning of this. So, this phenomenon can be seen all across the globe. Like you see here, the tiger chasing after a deer. The deer is a weaker one, tiger is a stronger one. So, in this world, you all agree that the mightier ones attack the weaker ones? But the mightier ones are also not independent. They also suffer. How? Like when a tiger comes out of the den, there is a bird which sits on the neck of the tiger and makes a sound, like that it makes a sound. Then all the animals flee, knowing the tiger is out now. So tiger is angry with the bird. Hey, why are you making sound and announcing about my arrival? But the bird flies and sits on a tree and tiger can't do anything. So the smaller ones, you know, non-cooperate with the bigger ones, and the bigger ones can trouble the smaller ones. Like for example, Prahlad and Hiranyakashipu. Prahlad was small, tiny, but his father was affected by that. And Hiranyakashipu, for Prahlad, he was torturing, troubling. That's material world like that. Like you see this picture, scientists also agree with this. They also say that, you know, the grass is eaten by the grasshopper is eaten by the bluebird, that is, bluebird is eaten by the snake, and snake is eaten by the owl. This is like ecological cycle, as you say, in the material world. So you see small fish is eaten by bigger fish, bigger one by even more bigger, like that. This is called jivo jivasya jivanam. It's not only that, a bigger businessman eating a lot of smaller businessmen and group with no mercy. Like for example, Nokia company was swallowed by another bigger company. You may be aware. Similarly, the WhatsApp was taken by Facebook, I think. Company like that. So this is material world. When British ruled over India, then the British ruled over the Indians, slaves. This is material world. But from material world, we go to spiritual world. We will see a total difference in spiritual world. So Krishna speaks in the Bhagavad Gita, this famous verse, that this material world is made up of Panchamahabhut. Like our bodies are also made up of Panchamahabhut, Bhumi Rapu Anula Vayu Kam. And inside this body there is a Sukshma Sharira, which is called Man Buddhi Ahankar. And inside that Man Buddhi Ahankar there is an Atma, which is the real you or the real me. We are present. At the time of death, what happens when a person's body lies down? The Atma with its Sukshma Sharir comes out, which means, which you call Antakarana, we call it, or Man Buddhi Ahankar. You all know Man Buddhi Ahankar, correct? Mind, intelligence, ego. What is the function of the mind? Mind is like a hard disk in a computer. It stores previous experiences, the desires, plans, ideas, and unfulfilled desires. All those things are stored in the mind. And intelligence is a decision maker. Intelligence. So, just like in a family, husband, wife and children. Similarly, husband is like intelligence, wife is like mind, and children are like the senses. So, the buddhi, man, indriya, they are all like that. But when you leave the body and go, at that time the atma is surrounded by that mind, which is carrying the vasanas from the previous life, which is sugandha vasanas, durgandha vasanas, we call it. Sugandha karma vasana means good activities you have done. Durgandha vasanas means bad activities that we have done. And there is also sukha-dukha proportionately in the next life. And whatever desires are not yet fulfilled, for that one more body is given, where you can give shape to those desires. Like right now we all possess a body. Why we got the body? Because we came with some desires. And when those desires are fulfilled, by the time some more new desires have cropped up. Correct? Now, like you go to a hotel to choose something to eat. And then while eating it, you see the menu. Now you develop desire to order something else also. So in this way, life after life, we are all fulfilling old desires, creating new desires, and going birth after birth like that, taking many, many bodies like that. That is material world. Now, sometimes you have seen poems also, some people say, I would like to fly like a butterfly, sing like a cuckoo, you know, swim like a fish, and people write poems. But that is only good for the poem, because when you are born as a butterfly, children will come and catch you. Isn't it? When you are a fish in the pond, some fisherman will come and put a hook and catch. In this world, you will see there is always danger at every step, like I showed you just a few minutes ago. Jivo, jivasya, jivanam. One living being becomes a food for another in this world. So, that is the nature of the material world. But a stage comes when one, over many, many lifetimes, his material desires are all fulfilled. Then a person starts thinking about Adhyatma. Where am I coming from originally? Because the rainwater, when it comes down, it is very pure. When it touches the ground, it becomes muddy. Again, you can purify it again. Similarly, after many, many, many lifetimes, we all think in this world, again and again, I am taking birth, I am getting old, I am getting diseases, I am dying. This is actually like a repetition. One gets tired of this. Even Shankaracharya in one prayer says, Punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam, punarapi janani, chatare shayanam, yeha samsare kaladostare kripaya pare, pahi murare, is saying, oh murare Krishna. How many more times I have to take birth like this? In several wombs of, every time you are born in a mother's womb, 9 months, both mother and child are in trouble. Mother has to bear the child for 9 months. And the child has to suffer the, you know, constricted pocket. And then afterwards, when we are born, in this world, you see, it's created in such a way that, like when I was a small kid, when you were 5 or 6 years old, we wouldn't go to any school. Nowadays, they put the children in pre-nursery, I think. Correct, no? In our days, we don't go to any school till 5th or 6th year. I used to play always. I thought I'll be in the lap of my mother all my life. But one day, my mother dressed me up in blue and white uniform with shoes and socks and everything. I asked, what is this new dress today? She said, today is a very special day. She took me to the bus stop and handed me over to one cocky conductor with a big mustache. So he picked me up and took me inside and closed the door of the bus. I was shocked. I cried like anything. I even bet him also. So he said, hey, keep quiet, don't make noise. All day I cried in the school and came in the evening. Mother was there to receive me in the evening. She was smilingly receiving me. I told her how the whole day passed to my mother. I thought going to school means only one day in your lifetime, I thought. Next day the same thing happened. Again she dressed me up in uniform and everything and sent me, you know. So I asked her, are you taking me to that fellow? She said, no, we are going to park just to have some, you know, light moments. We'll just have some time and come back. But then sure enough, she took me to the same bus. She put me in the bus and, you know, waved her hand. See, the child never likes to be separated from the mother. But this world is such a world that we all get separated from our near and dear ones. But then at least there's a hope that in the evening you can come back and see them. But then when you grow up, like when I went to America last time, one house they had a family gathering. 40 people had come, all the relatives. They told that yearly 1 week they meet like that. You know, some daughters in Australia, son is in Canada, another son is in US, you know, one is in Europe, different places. So nowadays people, even family people, are all scattered all over the world nowadays. It's very difficult to gather everybody together. So now once the school starts, you think life is cool after that? When you go to 7th, 8th, 9th standard, then many parents want their children to have a good career. Nowadays many of them want them to go to IIT, NITs, parents push, beta, get the first rank in the class, you know, you have to somehow crack and become engineer or a doctor or a chartered accountant, isn't it? So who is intention? Parents are intention or children are intention? Who? Parents. Actually both are intention. Parents are intention that children should situate themselves well, but children are intention that parents whom they love very much want them to prove themselves. So they are also intention. Okay, if the boy has completed the career, you think he is free after that? After the settlement in business or settlement in a job is also another big anxiety. Parents are always in anxiety, my son should not get into bad habits like drug addiction and things like that. If they have a daughter, they are worried that, you know, she should not elope with somebody. Yeah? There's always tension in this world. When you become old, there is always a fear that, oh, my knees are paining, back is paining. So you will see that in this world, at any point of time, there is always some suffering in this world. And suffering is mainly because we have this body made up of Panchamahabhut. But I told you in my last visit that there is a spiritual body which is free from all these kinds of limitations. It doesn't get old. It doesn't get diseases. It doesn't die at all. You live forever in that body. It's an eternal body. And Krishna speaks about it very elaborately in the second chapter. Earlier, scientists thought that these are all just Hindu mythology. They dismissed it. But in the recent few decades, hundreds of books have come out on science of reincarnation. Actually, there are Discovery Channel videos on children leaving one body. I mean, somebody left one body as James and then he reappeared in another family. Discovery Channel is actually presenting many scientific videos. So even they present about reincarnation studies. Now it's a proven fact all over the world. There are 25 universities offering MS on consciousness studies on the soul's reincarnation. So therefore, if we are not the body, we are the soul, and the soul never dies, never gets old, never gets disease, and the soul belongs to spiritual world. And the material body belongs to material world. You have heard the saying, from dust thou art born, from dust thou shalt return, it is said. This body is made of Panchamahabhut and the material world is also made up of Panchamahabhut. So Panchamahabhut mixes with Panchamahabhut, but the Atma never dies. So when Lalwani ji passed out of his body, you can be 100% assured that only his body, which was made of Panchamahabhut, mixed with the material elements, but the soul, along with the subtle body of Man, Buddhi, Ahankar, now whatever desires he had in his mind, he is carrying it, and he will take birth in another family. So Srila Prabhupada uses the word lucky family. He'll be born in a lucky family. Why? Because somebody is a Krishna devotee, they'll be born in a lucky family, where from childhood, you know, they will get to, you know, see an altar where Lord is worshipped. There'll be some bhajan kirtan going on, just like we had here now. There'll be some Gita part going on. There'll be katha going on. And the parents will be very cultured people. They will have all pure habits. So that kind of situation will be created for good souls like that. So therefore, the quality of consciousness which we carry at the time of death is very important. Like here you see, this is spiritual world. Krishna says, besides this material world, there is another world beyond this material world, which is spiritual world. So where the jivas are all pure, I'll be showing you a video about spiritual world also, I'll show you separately. See, this is our body, physic, gross body, subtle body, soul, I told you just now, correct, no? So Krishna says, how to see the God's hand in this material world? Just like you see this kantimala here, all the monies you are seeing, but you can't see the nylon thread which goes inside this. But if I remove that thread, what will happen? They will not get carried away. Similarly, this world in which we are living here now, he says that everything is revolving around Krishna, although we can't see Krishna eye to eye. But he says certain ways by which you can see him. Now I am going to show you that. He says, I am the taste of water, he says. We all actually, when we are very thirsty, you drink a glass of water, you feel deep satisfaction, correct, no? On the other hand, if you sometimes drink demineralized water, it does not taste, oftentimes. Actually, you will see that the essence of everything in this world is God. What is the essence of sun? The light and heat. That is God. The essence of water is taste. That is, also Krishna says, that's me, he says. See, I am the light of the sun. I am the light of the source of the moon, he says. Pranavas sarva vedeshu, he says. I am the Omkar in the Vedic literatures. Shabdakhe means I am the sound in ether. I am the Paurusham Rishu, I am the strength in man, he's saying. I am the prowess in man. I am the fragrance in earth, he says. See, when you take a rose seed and you cut it and smell it, you won't get any smell. But if you put it in the ground, when the rose plant grows and then rose comes, it will have a fragrance. So the rose seed takes the fragrance from the earth. The fragrance is in a... Actually, the program of fragrance is hidden in the earth. Similarly, I am the heat and heat of the fire, he says. And there are so many living beings. I am the food supplier for all of them. See, there are 8.4 million species like this. For all of them, I am the supplier of food, he says. See, even if a bird falls from the top like this, you know, he has made arrangements for them to be taken care of, see? I am the penance of the great ascetics, he says. In this way, one by one, all the living beings in this world, they get old, diseased, and then they leave the body, and then they occupy new bodies. And they take many, many bodies like this. And I am the original seed of all existences, he says. Like, for example, if all the mangoes in the world are destroyed, then not a single mango seed. Man cannot create mango seed. You have to go to Krishna and say, please give one mango seed. And then you have to sow. One mango seed is sown in the ground, you can get thousands of mangoes. But the original seed was given by Krishna, he says that. Like that for all species. Similarly, Buddhir Buddhimatamasmi, I am the intelligence of the intelligent, he says. Like Newton, how could he ask the question, why the apple is falling down? Huh? Because God gives the, like Einstein or Newton, they didn't create their own brain. God gave them the brain, correct, no? Like I was in Delhi in Apollo Hospital, one doctor had one nice placard on his table. It said, we treat, God heals. Like that they had written. So which means, you know, we can only try our best to treat somebody. But ultimately, who is the healer? God is the healer. Similarly, all the scientists will admit that they never created their own brain. God gives them the brain. Similarly, Tejasvi Namaham. I am the prowess of the powerful. Like here, of course, you see, similarly, Muhammad Ali said, I am the strongest, he said. But later on, Muhammad Ali actually got what do you call the Parkinson's disease? You can't even hold the Olympic torch. So that time he spoke a beautiful, very powerful sermon on God. He said, how God, you know, can give the power and take the power. He understood that. Yeah, similarly, Balam Balavatam Cham, I am the strength of the strong, he says. Similarly, Dharma Virudha Bhuteshu Kamosmi Bhartarshaba. If a man and woman come in married life together and they beget children and raise them in a God-conscious fashion, and that sex born of religious marriage is also me, he says. So now I will show you something about the spiritual world. So the spiritual world is a very vast world with innumerable spiritual planets, the spiritual effulgence. In one corner of this you see below, you see the material existence. You see this one below? In that Vishnu is lying and then he is creating millions of universes. This is like a sack inside which you may have crores of raika dana, you know, like mustard seeds. This is material existence. It's only in one corner. Actually, we are all inside this place now. You are seeing this? Inside one of those worlds, we are all there right now. But when you become liberated from this world altogether, you go into the spiritual world.
All the three worlds, both spiritual and mundane. Everything rests in me, Arjun, just as you see pearls hang upon a thread.
Yeah, I like that he said. Yeah. And not only he creates this world, he's so kind that he also gives the Vedic knowledge to Brahma originally. Because, you know, when we are all born in this world, somebody should be there to tell us, why are we here? There should be some plan for us, why we are here. I don't know how many of you have heard the story in Milton's famous story, which appears in the Bible also. It's a prodigal son story. The prodigal one father had two sons. And one son was the obedient one, and another one wasn't obedient one. The second one actually mixed with many of the bad people, and they all told him, you take your share, and then we can go and enjoy. So they misguided him. So he took his share from the father. Father wasn't happy at all, but he took it and went far away. And then they all squandered all his wealth. And then when his pocket was empty, they left him alone and went away. Then this poor fellow, not having any food to eat, so he went to one landlord, and who had 100 pigs. And the landlord told him that, you take care of these pigs and eat the same floor what you feed them. And he lived a very pathetic life. One day he cried tears and said, I wish to come back to my father, not as a son, at least as a servant. So he returned to the village. And again the father received him very gladly. And son said, but I have already taken my share and gone. Would you accept me as your servant? Father said, no, you are my very dear son. And he took him into his home. And they put up a big festival after that. So the son was taken by surprise that my father's love for me is never diminished, even though I acted against his interest. So the moral of the story is, like that son who turned away from the father and came to a faraway place, we all have come to this material world, which is an alien place for us, foreign place for us. Our actual home is spiritual world, about which I am very soon going to show you. In the material world, everything is temporary, as you see here. Everything is like, you know, the buildings become old after 100 years. They get, you know, broken down. Same with our body also. Although we would like to see our body is permanent forever. Is there anybody in this world who has lived permanently with the same bodies? 100, 200, 500, 1000, 3000, 5000. Like that many years, you have not seen anybody. Because the nature of the material world is, it is temporary. Here you see this kinds of six things are attracting us in this world. Somebody is very handsome, beautiful, we are attracted. Somebody is very rich, we are attracted. Somebody is genius of the century, we are attracted, isn't it? So these six opulences are attractive in this world. But we should not forget one important thing, that these opulences in this world will not remain forever. Like here you see, this lady is beautiful, but when she becomes 60, 70, 80, the beauty won't remain. Similarly, wealthy people also, the rank keeps changing. Somebody is first, now Bill Gates is not the richest man now. There is someone else, what's his name? You know, yeah? And he also will change after some time. Correct, now it keeps changing. So in this world, these opulences are like a jugnu, you know, glowworm, which is shining only in the night. It shines for a while. When the sun rises, they have no power after that. Similarly, in front of God's opulences, these have no power. So you will see, according to one's punya pap, one gets reactions like this. Okay, now I will go to the spiritual world PPT. So now we'll give you a glimpse of the spiritual world. Sound is coming there? You have to connect this. Give me a sound that's not been coming. This one? This is
okay.
I'll that mic it. वसन्ति यत्र पुरुषाः सर्वे वैकुण्ठमूर्तयः ये निमित्तनिमित्तेन धर्मेण आराधयन् हरिं. This verse says, in Vaikuntha planets, the men and women, they all have spiritual bodies. Like the men look like Vishnu. They also have four hands. And they also carry Shankachakra and all that. You'll wonder, hey, really? Lord Vishnu looks like with four hands and they also look like that. Just like Prime Minister of India and the citizens, they look similar. But the powers are different. Is it not true? So, the Prime Minister can declare a holiday for whole India on his birthday and it will be holiday, isn't it? Can any of us declare a holiday on our birthday for whole India? We can't do that. Our powers are different. So, in the spiritual world, Lord is supremely powerful and all others are servants. But they look very handsome and beautiful. And they are all engaged in devotion service without any kinds of selfishness there. Selfish desire for enjoyment. See, in this world, everybody in this world is asking, what is in it for me? What is in it for me? That's one of the famous slogans. There everybody is thinking, what is in it for serving Krishna? Here.
Kausalya Supraja Rama Purva Sandhya Pravartate
Uttishtha Rasha Dura Kartavyam Deva Mandhi. So, it says that there is Sattva, Vishuddha Sattva Guna there, which is completely pure. There is no rajas or tamas. Actually, rajaguna means passion, like you saw the tiger chasing after the deer, you saw. And tamaguna means ignorance, where people drink liquor, smoke cigarette and eat meat. And that is tamaguni life. Whereas in spiritual world, people lead very pure lives. Also, the description in the Kingdom of God chapter, 3rd canto, 15th chapter of Bhagavatam says this verse. It says that, Yatranai Shreyasam Nama Vanam Kama Dugai Drumaihi Sarvartu Shribir Vibrajat Kaivalyam Jiva Murtimat. One amazing thing is said here. In the spiritual world, there are trees which produce flowers and fruits throughout the year. See, in this world also, people sometimes store the fruits in cold storages. Whereas there, you don't have to store. Because in every month, all fruits, all flowers are available in the spiritual world. And they are called Kalpavriksha trees and Desire trees. And the beauty is, any tree can give you any of these fruits. Generally here, if you go to a banana tree and ask for a banana, they'll give you a banana. If you ask for a mango, they'll give you a banana only. Because Srila Prabhupada says they are not so conscious. They can only give you only one fruit only. Spiritual world, any tree can give you any fruit, any flowers, they are all capable. Yeah. So this is called the Kalpa Vriksha tree. Yeah. The birds and this one, here you see, in the spiritual world there are many birds. See, in the spiritual world there are many birds, like peacocks. You know, peacock sings very sweetly. Ngeo, ngeo. Neither they sing. And the cuckoo. Cuckoo. Cuckoo sing very sweetly, isn't it? So cuckoo, peacocks, parrots, they are called royal birds. You can see them all around. And they all sing very sweetly. While they were singing, at that time this honeybee comes there. Because honeybee has just now smelled the fragrance of, the garland of Lord Vishnu. And then after taking the honey from there, after hearing the glories of Vishnu, he wants to come and tell everybody now. So the honeybee is saying, can I tell you glories of Lord Vishnu? And all the other birds are welcoming him and they are keeping quiet. That means, the sweet singing birds are quiet and the ordinary humming bumblebee is given a chance to speak. Which means the spiritual world, nobody is proud of their own talent. Prabhupada says in the material world, even a donkey is very proud of his own braying, he says. And people, especially in the material world, want to show off to others that I am better than you. In spiritual world, everybody thinks, I am small, you are great. That is their consciousness. And they are not envious of each other also. Although other birds are exalted, they all are very eagerly hearing. Mandara kunda kurabotpala champakarna punnaga naga bakulam bujapari jataha gandherchite tulasika bharanena tasya yasmins tapasu manaso bahumana yanti. See, the first two lines of this verse talks 12 special flowers, which are fragrant flowers. You know chameli? The jasmine, very fragrant, isn't it? It may be small, but very fragrant. like that Nagakeshara, Bakula, Lotus, and they are all called royal fragrant flowers. Although they are all very, very fragrant, when Tulasi Maharani comes, you know, they all bow down to her. You will see here. See, when Tulasi, you know, Tulasi is kept in the lotus feet of Krishna, you all know that? In Vishnu's feet or Krishna's feet. Why Tulasi is kept? Because Tulasi is very, very dear to Lord. Tulasi is called Vishnu Toshini. I'll tell you one story about Tulasi from Padma Purana, then you will appreciate this point. In fact, in India, I have seen in Pune, even Bodhi Muslims also have Tulasi in their homes. They water it regularly every day. When I do a camp for 1,000 boys, I ask them, how many of you have Tulasi in your home? Everybody raises hand. We have a Tulasi in our home and they water Tulasi. But many people don't know why we water Tulasi. There's a great secret behind it. One time when there was one Sudharma, one Brahmana, along with one more Brahmana, two of them are walking in the jungle. Suddenly this Sudharma saw a bunch of Tulasi in the forest. Immediately he got some water from a nearby pond and offered water, and he bowed down and he circumambulated Tulasi three times. The other Brahmana was not a very learned one. He asked this Sudharma, hey, why are you doing all this? It seems to be ordinary plant. Why are you saluting like this? And he said, okay, let me tell you. So they sat under a very big vatavriksha, big banyan tree. And Sudharma started narrating the old pastime of Samudra Manthan Leela. You all heard of Samudra Manthan Leela? One side asuras, one side devatas. They were both churning the milk ocean. At that time, there was one Lord Dhanvantri who came with Amrit Kalash, you know, brought it. Dhanvantri is also Lord of Ayurveda also, Vishnu form. But when he brought the Kalash, he looked on both sides, there were asuras and devatas, and he had Ananda Bashpa, we call it, which is tears of joy. That the project is successful now. Although both are completely opposite in nature, asuras and devatas, still they work together and Amrita has come now. So he cried tears of joy, and when those tears fell in the pot, immediately Tulasi came there. Which means Tulasi is called Vishnu Toshini. Where Vishnu is satisfied, she is born there, it is said. So as he was narrating, suddenly at that time, the big Vatavriksha got uprooted. And dadal, with a big sound, it fell off. And both the Brahmanas jumped up away from there and they saw, what happened? Then out of that came a very effulgent devata, whose body was shining. And they asked, hey, who are you? Please tell me why this tree got uprooted. What is the reason? Then the devata told him, actually I belong to Gandharva Loka, up in the heaven. But long before, once I went to a hill station there, I saw one beautiful apsara. So I carried a bunch of flowers to give her, but she was running away from me. I threw it. At that time, she turned her face away and it fell on the lap of one great sage who was Agastya Rishi, sitting. Om, like that he was in Dhyana Mudra, sitting, doing Omkar. As soon as it fell in his feet, he immediately looked up. I saw that apsara, he became angry. He was about to curse her. She said, Swamiji, not me, you know, that fellow. Like that she showed her hand behind. Then the sage looked at him and said, you disturbed my meditation. So I curse you to become a Brahma Rakshas in Bhuloka, he said. And that fellow immediately got down from the mountain and fell at the feet of the Rishi and begged for Vimochan, some deliverance. So the sage told him, okay, since you have become humble now, I'll give you one benediction. Anybody glorifies Tulasi and Vishnu, you hear that glorification, you will be immediately delivered. Like that he said. So hundreds of years passed away. Poor fellow was Brahma Rakshas in that tree. But when these people were passing by, these two Brahmanas, they spoke glories of Vishnu and Tulasi, and then immediately he got delivered. So then he ascended back to his own abode after that. So according to Puranas, they say Tulasi Maharani is actually a manager of the spiritual world. She is the service allotter for everybody in spiritual world. So if you are watering Tulasi daily, you are having the habit and circumambulating and doing namaskar to her, Then when you go back to spiritual world, she will engage you in one of the services with Shriji or Radharani, huh? And she will give the opportunity for you to access the spiritual pastimes and everything. So anyone who touches the leaf of Tulasi, bows down to her, waters her circumambulator, they will attain Vaikuntha, it is said. So knowing this fact, all these colorful flowers and fragrant flowers, they are all bowing down to her. Now if you see Tulasi plant, is there any beautiful flower in Tulasi? No. Is there any fruit produced by Tulasi? No. But still they are all respecting her because she is called Krishna Priya. She is very dear to Krishna. That is the point. In this way there are many verses here. In the aeroplanes, in the spiritual world, of course, see, one attains when they go to spiritual world. There are Vaikuntha vasis, I was telling you. So that's the way they live. In the spiritual world, they are all engaged in seva of the Lord. And this is the last verse I told you I will recite in my class, which says that Brahma got a darshan of Vrindavan. See, till now I showed you Vaikuntha. Vaikuntha I was showing you. But in Vrindavan, he observed that Yatra naisarga durvaira saha sandra mrigadaya mitrani ajitavasa durtaruttarshakadikam. Somebody can read the translation? Madam, you can read this translation? You can give her the mic, give the mic to her. Yeah.
Vrindavan is the transcendental abode of the Lord where there is no hunger, anger or thirst. Though naturally inimical, both human beings and fierce animals live there together in transcendental friendship.
He says here, in Vrindavan there is no hunger, no anger or no thirst in Goloka Vrindavan. And he also saw that the humans and animals stay together in friendship because there in spiritual world the tiger also drinks milk only. They don't eat deer. The frog doesn't eat a fly. The eagle doesn't eat a frog. They don't eat anyone else. That this jivo jivas jivanam is not there in spiritual world. Spiritual world, there's a different formula. Jio jinedo. Live and let live. Whereas material world, the formula is jivo jivas jivanam. So therefore in spiritual world, there is no fear. In the material world, it's like this. So there is, all the animals live in fear in the material world like this. But when you want to see the spiritual world, you want to see? They live together in transcendental friendship. As I showed you, a glimpse of the spiritual world, one thing becomes very clear. In this world, people are generally very selfish. Spiritual world, people are very completely selfless. In this world, everybody thinks about, you know, for example, there is a great lack in gratitude in this world. But in spiritual world, it's a place of gratitude for the Lord. So in India, you will find children right from young age are so lovingly cared for by the parents. Because of which, when the children grow older, they have deep gratitude for the mother, for the father, for the grandmother, grandfather. And that is because of coming in our culture of Ramayana, Mahabharata culture in India. It's coming down in that lineage. So when the Western people, when they came to India, they saw the kind of family culture in India and they were deeply moved by this. Because in the West, it's very difficult to keep the families together. People change dozens of partners and they divided families. Whereas in India, you find this, because originally the scriptures talk about the spiritual world and its qualities. But when you see Rama, Lakshmana, Sita, you know, Bharat and all these characters exhibiting those qualities, then people are charmed and they adopt those values in their lives. And that is how you can find, even the material world can be made like spiritual world. Even though we are living on a material platform, like cutthroat competition is not only amongst animals. Even in human kingdom, man's life is becoming like a rat race nowadays. Is it not true? Even normal living has become spoiled because of modern day greed, the modern day people becoming too much self-centered. More the society becomes self-centered, it is a very painful society. On the contrary, families which are connected to God, who keep Krishna at the center and lead a very God-conscious life, they can bring the spiritual world culture to the material world. Like we say, it's like, there is a flight simulator. Even before you fly up in the sky, they have a flight simulator on earth where you are asked to practice, correct? Similarly, before going to spiritual world, we have to live those values on the earthly plane. If you can live, then only we are eligible to go there. So last time when I came, I was telling a few of my observations with Lalwaniji. I was remembering, he actually, although he's a very big businessman, he's very smart, very expert in his own field, in money making and dealing with all kinds of business people. But he used the talent in serving Lord Krishna. In fact, when he would come to the temple, he would be like a child. He would be like anybody else. He never considering any need for dignity or respect for him. He would sit with all other bhaktas in the temple hall. And he would, he would join the Ratyatra, distributing prasadam with everybody. And in the bhajan kirtan, he would be clapping hands like an innocent child. He had never had that pride that generally comes from high education or high birth or from high monetary circles. Very simple hearted. And also, he was always thinking of rendering seva. Whenever he came. In fact, he gave us a lot of ideas. Even for me, once he went to that big temple, Banjara Hills temple, he came and told me and Sitaram Prabhu, "Prabhu, in our temple I want to introduce one computer system." He said, "We should take database of all the people visiting the temple and we should give them prasad. You see, in that temple they are doing so many things. Our Madan Mohan temple people should come to know. And I will provide, in this kind of facility, you make one cabin here." So he gave a lot of ideas. Not only he gave donations for doing things in the temple, he also gave a lot of ideas and he felt a lot of nearness to the Lord. He removed all those cement flooring walls and everything and made it into marble, what you see today. So Thakur's service for someone having such eagerness to do, feeling for the Lord and feeling for the temple is extremely rare. And that kind of thing comes after many, many lifetimes. In Gita also, Lord Krishna says that, when we come from the spiritual world to this world, we wander in many, many lifetimes. Initially, we are only thinking about I, me, mine for many, many lifetimes. Then gradually one becomes, one may meet some brahmanas, do some puja, then one may go to the temple. Then after many, many lifetimes, one becomes a jnani. One may study some Vedas, Upanishads and all. Then one may come to the platform of yogi. Then one understands the Lord Krishna is supreme, Vishnu is supreme. Then they worship. At last one comes after many lifetimes. And that time, then also one does bhakti for a long time. And then gradually purer and purer and purer. Then finally one goes back to the same place from where we have come originally. Many people ask, why God is putting us through so many lives? It's like you take a marble block and you chisel out unwanted portion, a beautiful murti comes out, right? No? God is also chiseling out unwanted things from us. What are the unwanted things? We become angry, we become greedy, we get all those shadaripus we say, no? Kama, krodha, lobha, madha, moha, matsarya. Those have to be removed from us. So life after life, God is giving us chance to get rid of unwanted things. And then the beautiful personality comes out when we become a pure bhakta. So he utilized this opportunity very well in this life. He was externally for worldly people. He was like a worldly man. Many people like Mahendra Vijayvargiya and other people told us that many business people consider him very successful. In his business, they consider him only expert in the business. They don't know beyond that, but they are devotees, so they know also. There are 3-4 other donors in our temple who associate with him very closely. They are all thick friends in their circle, so they know how sincerely he practiced devotion. And so either Lalwaniji would have gone back to the same world what I showed you today, where he meets the Lord face to face, and that's an eternal life. Just like in this world, our life goes on for 80, 90 years. After that, we leave the body. There, nobody lives. You live forever. God will never die, we will never die, and the Sambandha will never die. It's eternal, it is. So it's a happy world where it is said, there's no water there, there's only honey there. Nobody walks there, everybody dances there. Nobody talks there, everybody sings there, poems. And while exchanging with each other, they only sing poems there, it is said. It's a very beautiful world where there is no old age, disease, or death, or sorrow. There's no separation. So that separation, pain is there only in this world. But if we understand the spirit of Lalwaniji and adopt that spirit in your life, you will also go to a zone of timelessness where he will never be separated from us. Actually, when somebody like him leaves the world, we simultaneously experience joy and sorrow. Why we experience joy? That he lived a very virtuous life and he has left behind a legacy which will be adored and remembered for a long time to come by many people, and we can emulate many of his good qualities in our lives. And also we are very happy that, because he lived his life very successfully, his next life is very bhavishya bada ujjwala unki. His future is very bright. God is personally going to escort him. He has gone into the loving embrace of Krishna. That much you can be very confident. And why do we feel sorrow? We feel sorrow that such a wonderful person, his association we have lost now. And we can't get to have that joy of talking to him, hearing from him, exchanging with him. So that pain will be there in us. So we are still in the material world with material body, so we experience the pain. He has left the body and he has gone to the next... he has promoted to the higher spiritual, joyful realm. And he'll be smiling at all of us from there, in his position. So we pray that these 12 days, that you all are meeting many devotees and doing bhajan, doing Gita path, such auspicious things you are doing for the supreme welfare of Rajkumar Lalwaniji. This is the best thing you can do for him. Because in this world, currency notes don't go with us. Nothing goes with us. We leave behind everything. Just like when you are going to America or London, the airport, they screen out so many things, correct? No? In the same manner, everything material is screened out. Everything spiritual is allowed. And he carried a lot of spiritual wealth with him. And therefore, you can be assured and you can be confident that with all the spiritual wealth he carried, his future is very glorious. Hare Krishna. Thank you. Now I can take some
questions. We can ask questions.
And you can circulate the mic around if somebody wishes to have the mic.
Who would like to start first?
Yeah, please.
Before you ask question, you can just tell your name also.
Hi, I'm Rishi Bajaj. Hi. Thank you for being with us and taking some questions. This is a question that's come online from someone on YouTube.
Yeah.
So they're saying, how does one know what the spiritual world looks like if no one has, over here, has been there?
Good question. See, how does a little child know who is my father? For example, any of you have small babies. The baby knows only one relationship. Who is that? Mother. Because mother gives breast milk. child knows that this is the most favorite person for me, he thinks, because she gives me breast milk, he drinks. Oh, you know, when it is cold, she puts a, you know, napkin around me, or, you know, when it is hot, she puts on the fan. This lady is so nice, and, you know, I am totally dependent on her. Like the child is thinking. When child, few more days, few months he spends, then the child is looking at another man who is coming and going. So he's asking the mother, who is this fellow who is coming going? Then the mother says, this is your father. So child comes to know of the father from whom? The mother only. Now if somebody says, no, I won't accept the version of the mother, I'll find out who is my father by genetic fingerprint. There is a scientific method to find out your father. But the problem is that will take 800 years for you to find out your father based on genetic fingerprint. But after 800 years also, the scientists can give you 200 male fatherable personalities. From that 200, you have to pick up one. Is it very easy? It's a very laborious process, isn't it? So what is the easiest thing is we trust the mother and we accept the father's identity from the mother. In the same manner, the Vedas are like the mother. And they are giving, showing hand to the father. This is the father. Now, why should you accept the Vedas? You know, Vedas are coming down from the dawn of creation. The Vedas were not even written down. They were coming by word of mouth. But 5,000 years ago, Vedavyasa wrote it all down, thinking that Kali Yuga has started now. So he put it down. Now, why do we trust the Vedas? There are many scientific things that the Vedas say, which man never knew before. Now man is accepting. For example, the Vedas use the word chara achara. Chara means moving living beings. Achara means non-moving living beings like the trees and plants. Now scientists said trees and plants have no life. Very confidently they said. Why? Because they are not moving. But then Jagadish Chandra Bose some 5 decades ago proved that plants and trees also have life. But Vedas said this truth millions of years ago. That means we come to understand that science is discovering certain things now which were told in Vedas million years ago. Another example I'll tell you, when Indians used to do Surya Namaskar and all, worldwide people would ridicule it. They never took it seriously in those days. They thought, why these fellows are not going for gym and showing off the biceps, you know? Why are they not going for acrobatic activities and all? They are doing yogasanas. But now the whole world is turning to yogasanas now, all over the world. Even Gulf countries, they are inviting Indian gurus for learning yogasanas now. You can see that. Now in the same manner, worldwide, the Vastu Shastra has become very popular now. Now the Jyotish Shastra of India has become very popular. So many of the things from the Vedic literature, like for example, NASA is having an entire department for Sanskrit professors who are actually decoding the Vedic Vimana Shastra and giving them clue on how to make the flying saucers. Using mercury, because mercury is a metal which is also liquid. It's very rare metal because no metal is liquid, only mercury is the only one. So Vedas are giving such clues for the scientists also now. So we are not hearing one or two. I can give you a link of Vedas and science. I can, Mukundatva, I'll mail it to you, you can share it with all. So that has got, you know, several tens of GBs of information about Vedas and science matching. Matching means what? Vedas told it first. Science found it next. That kind of things. Many, many things are there. So after seeing all these things, you develop a credibility in the Vedas. Because Vedas are saying these things, like for example, scientists never agreed about existence of soul before, long before. They thought it Hindu mythology. But then, not only in India, all across the globe, there is one Dr. Ian Stevenson, you know, in University of West Virginia. He discovered 3,000 cases of people remembering their Purva Janma. And he got a doctorate degree. He was the first one. Then after that, in Pune also, Satvan Parisha, one lady. Like that, there are thousands of scientists who are getting doctorate degrees on reincarnation studies and approved by East and West universities now. So soul is a very well scientifically accepted term now. So which was never known to scientists. Scientists are actually trying to suppress. In my school days, I read about somebody remembering Purva Janma. But scientists were trying to brush it aside. They were worried that if this becomes true, people will lose faith in science and have more faith in Vedas. But now you can't hide. It's like hiding a sun in the sky. So when Vedas are giving such strongly provable evidences, then we can also trust the Vedas in this aspect of spiritual world, because they are only giving us the truth. They are telling that such a world exists. So I have one whole session on what is the proof that spiritual world exists. I have a whole session on that. There are about 6 or 7 proofs we can give how spiritual world exists. Because many of the modern day young students ask such questions. So we explain about that. For example, in this world, whatever you see, beauty, strength and all those things, these are a perverted reflection of the oceanic beauty and strength existing in the spiritual world. So if you see object in reflection, like if you see a mango in the water, there must be a real mango tree having mango, correct? No, otherwise how do you see the reflection? So in this way we can establish systematically step by step. There are more questions? More questions? Yeah. You can give the mic. Anybody here want to ask questions? Yeah, here you can give it to her.
So as I knew my father, he was a very pure devotee.
Yeah.
Just wanted to ask you, what are the qualities, you know, that we can learn from him and adopt? Because we know a lot of things, but there might be few more that, you know, you can tell us and then.
Yeah. Actually, I feel that, one of the things that I observed in him is he was never too busy in, making money alone, which is what we find with most of the modern day people nowadays. They are foaming in the mouth and saying that, let me make money now. When I get old, I will come to God. People say, he never was like that. He had a very regular habit of visiting the temple, taking darshan, bowing down before the deity, circumambulating the deity, accepting prasad. So I feel that this is a very good lesson for the next generation, that we should be consistent. Just like we brush our teeth every day. We take a bath for the body. If you don't do, mouth will be stinking, body will be stinking. And if we don't chant God's names, then our mind will be stinking and we will give trouble to everybody around us. Correct, no? But when we are chanting the Gita shlokas, we are chanting Hare Krishna, then we can clean our heart. Then people around us will feel very happy to associate with. And therefore, he was actually regular in all these things, uncompromising. Another thing I feel we can learn is, Shastras say that, like Brahmachari means you should control his senses and mind and study the Vedic literature. If somebody is a Grihastha, they have many duties like that. They have to do the duty of giving charity. He was always very fond of giving charity for temple activities. Like, he would sponsor the prasadam, he would sponsor the building of the altar, sponsor the dress for the deities, like that. So giving charity, people who can totally dedicate their life, they should dedicate our lives, like myself and some of us are doing. And those people who can give charity should give charity. Everybody has some ability God has given us, and they should utilize that. That is another thing I observed in him. And also he was extremely respectful to saintly people. He would often tell us when he would meet us that, when I talk to other businessmen, my mood is different. Because I talk from business expertise point of view, but when I come to temple, what devotional thing can I speak? I am more in a position to hear, like that he would say. So that was another thing I told you about his humility. His humility. Humility actually means not anxious to be respected by all, not considering oneself very self-important. So that is a very unassuming nature. Actually, great kings had that. Like if you see the Prataparudra, king of Odisha, in front of Jagannath Rath Ghat, he would come and sweep the floor, wanting to tell the world that actual king is Jagannath. I am only his servant. So that mood is a very, very magnetic mood which charms the heart of everybody. That is one of his moods also. And during the COVID period, we found another interesting thing. We four of us, HTMC members, Hyderabad Temple Management Council members, we were making a plan that nobody will be allowed in the temple. So we locked the gate. You all know that everyone and everything was locked down all over. Everybody was within four walls. So after we made the lockdown, we got a phone call from him, from Lalwaniji. They said, lockdown for whom? He asked us. So we told, lockdown for everybody, he said. But I am not outsider, I am an insider. You all know very well that I have a relationship with Radha Madan Mohanji. You cannot punish me like this, that not non-entry policy in the temple. So At that time, actually, we don't decide alone. We all four of us decide together anything we do. So he told Sitarampu told me that I said immediately that, and actually he's an insider, everybody knows that. And then immediately we decided the next day we called him. But before that, a dozen calls came from him. What are the decisions? What have they planned? So which goes to show that his devotion to God was not ordinary. Certainly it was a very strong inner call he had for service to God. It was not just on the platform of duty. It is beyond the call of duty, actually. These are things that I got to observe personally, myself. Yeah. Our Sitaram Prabhu is in Calcutta now. Now he will be coming in a few days, and he and Lalwani used to spend hours together, actually, in the shop. And he will also visit one of the days. Yeah. But I come 1 week in a month here to Hyderabad. So whenever I came here, and we invited him in our meetings sometimes, because he has a lot of ideas. He is a very good idea giver. Once he told us 15-20 ideas, we were feeling that we didn't note it down. So later on, one of the devotees took his smartphone and started noting. He's an idea man. He always thinks on how to do the things better. Krishna keeps supplying him very good ideas. Yeah, very good soul with so many valuable thoughts. And as long as he was amidst us, he did a lot of great good. Left behind a very powerful, shining example. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. And
next.
Hare Krishna Prabhu, my name is Sanjana. Actually, I have two questions. One is, now that we heard this lecture and we got some knowledge, how do we imply that in our lives for someone who is completely new and wants to inculcate spirituality in their lives?
Yeah. I will suggest that you could take one 8-session course we have, which will be 1 hour each like this. Actually, today we just had one general talk we had today. But if you go from the basics, you know, one of the lectures is on, does God exist? Even that kind of question. Then we have about one on the soul, you know, one on karma, like that. We have 8 topics. We have 1 hour each. We have videos also available. I will send the link to him. You could hear it at your own home in our leisure. So that will be like a foundation for you, for the spirituality. There also you get some practical action points. I will tell you briefly, which is called ABCDE, we call it. ABCDE. A for association. So this is called as association. You come in the group of like-minded people. Like, you know, we just don't want to just make money in life. Not only we want to make a very good academic career in life. Not only we want to become popular in this world. Because we know that the life term given to us in this world is a certain period. And if something like soul exists, different from the body, and that is our true identity, then it is also in our interest to do something better for our future. Correct, no? So therefore, we should come in satsanga. Satsanga actually helps you to become a better individual in this world also. You know, you develop qualities like tolerance, patience, humility, courteousness, friendliness, cooperativeness, flexibility. You know, such kinds of qualities you develop. And also you respect others' abilities and opinions. Correct, no? And you don't think only about yourself, you think of the others also. So the home can be a very happy home by coming to the association. So that is A for association. And also it depends on whom you associate with. Like, you know, I heard a story of two parrots, you know. When they were sold in the market, they were brothers. But one was sold to a king, one was sold to a butcher. Later on, when Sadhu was walking on the road, the one which was sold to butcher's shop was shouting, "Cut him! Catch him, kill him," like that he was shouting. Whereas the king's parrot was speaking sweet words. "My dear sage, please take your seat. The king has gone for a stroll. He'll come back soon. Would you like to drink some juice?" Like that he was talking. The sage was put to great surprise, you know. How is it that this fellow, both were brothers and one behaved so well, one is behaving just the opposite? It's all due to association. Correct, no? And the second B is for Bhagavad Gita, you know. You were saying that, you know, you are all reading Bhagavad Gita, no? You have Bhagavad Gita at home here, correct, no? That's a very good book, life guide for us. C for chanting. Water. I take hot water. So, why is Naam Jap important? You go to any religion, even Muslims chant on their rosaries, you know. Christians chant Hail Mary, they also have a mala. Buddhists chant also Namo Abhida Butsu, they also do. Even all religions you will see. So we have a mala with us. No? Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Each morning one mantra. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. This is actually a prayer actually. So when you do this prayer 108 times you do in a day, just make a beginning and see for a week, it makes a big difference. And generally our lives are so fast paced nowadays, and many people are getting brain stroke nowadays because of the hyperactive lifestyle. So this chanting will actually teach you the art of sitting in one place, calming your mind and cooling down your mind. It's like a radiator in a car which cools the engine. So this is chanting. And D for diet. We should, whatever food we eat, we keep in front of God and thank Him first before we eat it. And that we call as prasadam. If you don't eat prasad, then it is considered sinful food. In fact, even in Quran it is said, if you buy a cow, for example, they even eat cows also. One should cut the cow into 8 parts. And 7 parts they have to give in charity. And only 1 part they can eat. And that is called halal, they call it. Otherwise haram, they say. Which means 2 principles they follow. It is only cut in the mosque, not in a slaughterhouse. And it is, 7 parts is given away means they are discouraging eating. Because who will buy 80,000 rupees cow and eat only 10,000 worth? And 7,000 is give away. That means meat eating is discouraged very heavily, and also doing in conjunction with God is encouraged. Because in this world, none of the grains, fruits, cereals can be created by any man. Scientists can talk big things. They can give you electronic chips. They can't give you potato chips. God only gives you eatables. So that is diet. And E for etiquettes and manners. How to deal with superiors like mother, father, and others. How to deal with those who are younger to you, those who are equal to you, how to deal with members of the opposite sex, how to deal with animals, how to deal with the environment. So that's called etiquettes and behavior, we call it. And that is also taught in the scriptures. So if you learn these 5 things, you can be a complete human being, if you learn these 5 things. For example, in human life, you see there are 4 very important aspects, which most people don't follow all the 4. So physical, emotional, intellectual, and spiritual, we say. If you take care of the physical body by good exercises, one is called as a good animal, If one is keeping good relationships with family members, one is called as a good friend. And colleagues also. Good friend. And if one is very good in business and also his profession, one is called as a good craftsman. And if you know how to take time out for God and connect with God, you are called as a good saint. If you combine all these 4, good animal, good friend, good craftsman, and good saint, you are a complete human being. But do you think most people, follow all the 4? They lack in at least 2. Most people think God is only when you get old. They keep it for beyond 80. And some people focus on profession, neglecting the family. Some people focus on family, neglecting profession. And most people run after money. That's very common. But if you come to spiritual life, you will learn combination of all the 4. Because we balance in everything. There's time to do yogasanas. There's a time to relate with people. And we emphasize on 3 duties. Family, professional, devotional. Like a tripod. One leg you take off, your life cannot go smoothly. Because if you don't go near God every day, you are going to quarrel with your family members. And you are going to quarrel with your professional partners also. And if you are taking care of God and profession, then family will be unattended. And if you are taking care of God and family, then profession will suffer. So all the 3 have to be balanced. Correct, no? So spirituality actually teaches balance. How to keep balance of all these things. Is that all right?
Thank you, Prabhu.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
You all know Mukunda Hari Prabhu. Actually, Mukunda Hari Prabhu only originally invited me here. He told me also. I was planning to come on one of the days, randomly, I wasn't sure. The day I was thinking in my mind, the same day he came and met me, Mukunda Hari Prabhu. He's one of the very active members here in Pune, in Hyderabad, here. And he told me also he knows Lalwani and family very well. And through him, I will send you the details and all for the 8-session course. And I can share that, yeah. And you can share with others, whoever wishes to see, they have time, they can see that. Because many of them may not be able to fix a time and come for a particular course in the temple or anything. Mm-hmm. But if you give them the videos, they could watch at their own leisure. Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Hare Krishna. Yeah.
My name is Nikhil. Prabhuji, just a simple thing which troubles me quite often is the need to establish supremacy. Yeah. Say, like, for ISKCON, Krishna is supreme. Similarly for, you know, Brahma Kumari, Radha Swami.
Yeah, within different the organizations.
Hindu, within the Hindu, you know, there are so many so many ways of achieving whatever we are all after. This conflict, I mean, what is your opinion on this conflict, Prabhuji?
Between the different organizations.
Yeah.
And yeah, actually, why there are different organizations, that is also very important to know. Huh? You will find that there are three gunas. Lord Krishna explains in Bhagavad Gita, Tamaguna, Rajaguna and Sattvaguna. In the three gunas, the worship is also different. In the Tamaguna, for example, Shiva and Durga worship and people cut the goats and chicken and all. On Amavasya day, they are allowed to take 5 M's, you know, Matsya, Mura, Mams, Madira and Maithun, 5 things. And if somebody is accepting only on Amavasya day, once in a month, he is considered a great soul in their community. He eats fish. He eats meat, he drinks wine, you know, he can associate with a woman and like that, 5 things. But in Rajoguna when you come, then the worshippers worship different people like Ganesh, Kartikeya, and different people they worship like that. When you come to Sattvaguna, 3 deities are worshipped: Lakshmi Narayan, Sitaram, Radha Krishna. And these deities are worshipped with pure items, like we offer vegetarian food along with tulasi leaf, like that. And the lifestyle is very pure. When you come to Sattvaguna, people won't drink, they won't smoke, they won't have any illicit connections, and they will offer pure food to God. And the lifestyle is basically very simple, very highly Brahminical. You will see that. In Tamaguna worship, all those other bad items are there. So, now the organizations also give for different type of people, yeah.
But all three deliver? They all three take you to where you want to go?
No. After these 3 worships, for example, if you worship any devata, Ganesha, the people generally go to them only for material benefits. See, there are 4 platforms, fear, desire, duty, love. So some people out of fear they worship. They think that, you know, if you don't worship God, he will punish us or something. That's a very low motivator. But desire is a very common motivator, that, you know, I want to success in business, or I want good scores in my academics. So 99% of the population goes on desire platform, you know. And above that is duty platform, where a person thinks that, oh, God has given me the sunlight, moonlight, rains and grains and everything. There are a few people who do that. They think, you know, it's our duty to go to temple and say thank you and come. But for them also, duty people also, they are more concerned about worldly lifestyle. God is one small component of their life. If they have 20 things to do in life, God is one of those things. Whereas the love platform is the topmost and the purest platform, where you connect with God not for any material commodity. You simply want to love and serve Him. Just like your mother wants to serve you. You know, what is her motivation? Simply out of love she does. Whereas in a shop, a shopkeeper is selling bhaji, pakoda and all, very nice smelling. When if you eat it, you will get stomachache. Because he is business minded. He will use recycled oil and cook like that. Is it not true? There's no. He loves your pocket, not you. But your mother, she loves your heart. She serves without an expectation. You go to a hotel, a waiter is smiling. He smiles, you know what is the smile, you know. You go to the airport, the air hostess also wish you good morning. Or the receptionist in star hotels. So these are all artificial smile, you know that. But the real smile is coming from your mother. So that is genuine love. Same with the devotees who relate with God. Like Sudama went to Dwaraka. But he didn't expect anything from Krishna. He was very poverty stricken. He was wearing tattered clothes. His bones were visible. But he asked, he's such a loving friend of mine. How can I ask for anything from him? It would be ridiculous to, you know, go and praise him and ask for some goods for myself. I would rather live in poverty, he said. So he went and spent a week with him very nicely, remembering their good old days in Gurukula, and came back. He didn't ask anything, but Krishna, without even asking, you know what Krishna gave. So you will see that love is the only commodity exchanged between devotees and the Supreme Lord. So therefore, they are the ones who will attend the spiritual world when you come to that platform. For example, if you like Shiva worshippers, for example, say Sadguru, for example, is teaching Shiva worship. They go out to the borderline between material and spiritual, which means, see, right now we are all negative axis. And the borderline between material and spiritual world is 0-0. Brahma Jyoti, we call it. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti, they say, no? So they are after peace. They want to get rid of the cycle of birth and death and go to the peace platform where there is no activity. But what we are talking about is beyond the 0-0 positive axis, where you enter the Brahma Jyoti. The core of Brahma Jyoti is the spiritual planets, where you meet Lakshmi Narayan or Sita Rama or Radha Krishna, depending on your relationship with them. And then you see the Lord's personality. So you have a choice whether you want to meet him one-on-one personally. Just like, for example, these children, these sons and daughters of, you know, all of you of Lalwaniji, you relate with him as a person, correct? No? Now your relationship is very intimate, but now Lalwaniji's relationship in the professional field will be very formal. Here at home, he is very informal. Similarly, Vishnu and Narayan, and Vishnu and Ram, their relationship with devotees is very formal. Like Prime Minister of India meeting MPs and MLAs, like that. Whereas the same Lord at home is Krishna, is very intimate. Just like Narendra Modi ji having relation with mother and sister and brother, like that, intimate. So you can choose, you want to relate with God intimately or formally. Accordingly, people go to those planets. Or if you don't want to meet God personally at all, you say that I'll pay tax to the government and I'll be a citizen in India. Then you go to Brahma Jyoti, where you don't see God's form. You are a jnani. Now people like Sadhguru and other people, they may be teaching good values and everything. And they do meditation. And they will go to, even the Brahma Kumaris, for example, Shiv Baba, they worship. If you ask them, meditate on red light, they will say. So they will go to the Shanti platform. And they remain there for a long period of time in Shanti. But the problem is what? That is a metastable state. It's not a stable state. Because in want of activity, the Nishkriya, Jiva cannot be Nishkriya. He has to be Sakriya. Like even now we are all very active, correct, no? See, you know Sakris? Children do. We have done in our school days. So even inside a sack, we run very fast. We jump, you know, we get a prize, first prize, second prize and all in sack race. But if you remove the sack, you can run far more faster. Similarly, Atma is right now inside the sack of material body. Even now we are so active. If you release Atma, how much more active he will want to be. And if you don't give him activity, you put him in a Shanti Shanti platform 0-0, in want of activity, he will fall down again. Aruhya kritrena param padam tataha patanti ado anadritishmadangreha, it is said. Then again, he will have to go on birth and death again. Until he attains the platform of love, then he will cross 0-0 and go to the positive axis. Then after many lifetimes, they will go back to God. Therefore, there are multiple destinations. Those who worship devatas like Ganesh and others asking material benefit, they will be rotating in the material world only. They will not even go to 0-0. They will be negative axis only. So am I saying too many things or is it clear? Now it's very clear. See, now I'll ask you a simple question. Say husband and wife. Now they married at the time of marriage, everything was wonderful. But sometimes after 3, 4, 5 years, familiarity breeds contempt. We say, no? Like we say, ati prachayat, avajnyat. Therefore, spiritual connection is very important. When there is spiritual connection, they will see Sita Ram example, how they lived. Sita never gets bored with Ram. Ram never gets bored with Sita. Same with Lakshmi Narayan. Lakshmi never complains how long I have to massage your feet. You know the reason why? The reason is, Vishnu is always telling Lakshmi, I have a place for you in my chest as a golden hair. You come and reside in my chest and be peaceful. But she is telling, no, 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 I want to serve. She wants to serve, he wants her to be peaceful. That means he is concerned about her and she is concerned about him. Therefore, that love never rests. It's ever fresh love. But in this material world, we find husband-wife relationship sometimes becomes bitter. They have to make it better. How they can make it better instead of bitter? Then spiritual connection will help. Now, in the negative axis, when the relationships become bitter, sometimes uncontrollably they become angry, both of them. Then they initially begin fault finding in each other. Eventually start yelling, shouting and all. Then both of them decide that this is becoming too much. And nowadays, nuclear families. So they say, oh, you live in that room, I will live in this room. So now 1 week they are living separately. Are they peaceful or not? They are peaceful. Why quarrel is not there? You know, she cooks the food and keeps in a tiffin and says, food is here, tiffin, take it. And that fellow brings a salary pack and keeps in the tiffin and says, salary is here, keep it inside. They leave a chit. Will they be peaceful or not? They'll be peaceful. But is it the ideal platform? Is it the ideal platform? Ideal platform is what? They should again come together and say, okay, let us stop quarreling. Let us forget the past. Let us look at the future ahead. Because you know, sometimes difference in opinions come. Like the mother wants a child to go to the vernacular medium and the father wants a child to go to English medium, you know. So there are differences in raising the child between mother and father. So quarreling means negative axis. Living in two separate rooms means zero zero. Even Vipassana meditation, you know Vipassana meditation people, they teach you to go to zero zero, Nirvana, that's all. But our Vaishnava movements like ours teaches you to go to positive axis, where husband and wife should lovingly stay together, bending one another, be flexible, be adaptable, be understandable, you know. Let us, one time I will forgive you, next time you forgive me. Forgiven are those who forgive others. It is a, and that is love platform. So now you tell me, do you like the quarrel platform, peace platform or love platform? Yeah. Therefore I chose this organization. Because I have been to all those organizations before. I went to more than a dozen organizations. I actually wanted to dedicate my life in my 7th standard itself. You know, 7th onwards I went to Ramakrishna Mission, Chinmaya Mission, like that many organizations, Shivananda Ashram, Ramana Maharshi. I have even met sannyasis, asked questions to them about what is the culmination, what they want to attain. So Advaitam, Advaitam, Ishtadvaitam, Dvaitadvaitam, Shuddhadvaitam, many different. And Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu synthesized all of them. Now what I am telling you is a glow, like a bird's eye view of different philosophies. Jains, they will tell you, we have to go beyond the wheel of samsara, they will say. But where you ask them, they will not have much information. They won't be able to give. They will say that you go beyond the samsara, you won't suffer, they will say. So it's more like, you know, I want to go from negative to zero zero. For example, if I call you here and I pinch you all over your body, you say, Prabhuji, why are you pinching me? It's paining. I say, go back and sit in your seat. Now are you happy if I ask you? You will be happy, but that happiness is basically relief from the pinch. And that's what most religions teach you. But what we are teaching is, you call a person and give him gulab jamun, you eat now. That is positive axis. Correct, no? So we don't tell people, like for example, many religions teach you how to give up things of this world. Correct, no? They don't do this, don't do that. We don't do that. We say, chodna nahin, jodna hai. We say, connect everything to God. You can do actually, like you are a singer, you sing God's names. You are a dancer, then dance for God. You are a painter, then paint for Krishna. Correct. Now you are a speaker, then speak His glories. So in this way, we don't suppress. You've seen those three monkeys. Bura mat dekho, bura mat suno, bura mat bolo. Theek hai? Bura mat dekho, mat suno, mat dekho. Kisko bolna chahiye? Jo bura dekh raha hai. Somebody is saying wrong things or hearing wrong things, you'll tell him. But it is not sakaratmak, it is nakaratmak. And what is sakaratmak? You tell them with your eyes, see the beautiful deities of Radha and Krishna. This is our Pune, Radha Vrindavan Chandra. You see the beauty, if you see their beauty, then you will not be attracted to false beauties as well. Similarly with your ears, you don't have to suppress the ear. Hear the katha like this, Krishna katha. hear about Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, nice things you hear, which will actually make you more, become more virtuous in life. Similarly, you know, don't speak bad means like our Pythagoras said. You know, speak fitly or be silent, he said. Those who are talking nonsense, they should be told, don't talk. But if somebody can speak something valuable for the world, like I speak 7-8 lectures every day, many of the days. Why we can speak? Because we are studying Shastra and telling people nice things, which is actually elevating the people. Why should we keep our mouth shut? Why should we do mauna vrat? Rather, we should speak to the best energy, whatever we have. Isn't it? So do you like a nakaratmak religion or a sakaratmak religion? Correct? Sakaratmak means it's constructive, positive. Use your senses in the positive direction and elevate yourself and be, you uplift yourself and be uplifting to the world around you, rather than being in a mode of denial. Now with this map that I gave you today, you evaluate all the different organizations. Most of them teach you negation. Negation means negating the world, many of them. Actually we are sadhus, we live in the heart of the city. And we go to schools, colleges, companies, because we want to serve the suffering souls. We don't want to go to Himalayas and sit in meditation and work for our own moksha. We want to see, why only I should get moksha, let everybody get. And also our method is very, very simple. Chanting Hare Krishna, even a household lady with a child can do that. You know, offering, cooking in the kitchen, offering bhoga to Lord and accepting. So, you know, these kind of simple methods are there, and Bhakti Yoga is a very easy to apply process also it is. Yeah. Now, and also, why people treat, like for example, somebody is telling you to meditate on red light or something like that. God is not just light. God is a source of light also. But He is not light, He is a person. You are a person, I am a person, she is a person, everybody is a person. How can we be persons and He not be a person? In this world you see butterfly is a person, dog is a person, cat is a person, everybody is a person. Ultimately, impersonalism comes from personal. If you see the bulb, for example, is having a form. But the light pervading the room is impersonal. Correct, no? So anywhere you see something impersonal, it will have its source in the personal. You will see. Electricity is impersonal. But you go to the hydroelectric power station, there a man is generating electricity, he is person. You will see that ultimately. So I won't just give examples, but if somebody wants to know the Shastri codes, there are Upanishadic codes, Shruti Mantras, Vedic codes, you know, Vedanta Sutra. Generally, if I meet any other organization person comes to me, I will give all codes. And I didn't flood you with Sanskrit codes now, so that I will be able to make more sense to you, you know. Otherwise, I can quote after quote, dozens of codes we can give. So, therefore, our basis should be based on the scripture. Scripture teaches all the three. Brahman, Paramatma, Bhagavan. You can understand God as an impersonal light. It's called as Param Jyoti. But where is that light coming from? From Bhagavan. Bhagavan's the Shruti Mantra say that Vedahametam Purusham Mahantam Aditya Varnam. His body is shining like sunlight. For Jnanis, He shows only the light. Because they don't have faith in person. But for bhaktas, He shows the personality. So if you love Him, He will show you His personal form. And if you don't love Him, if you treat Him formally, then He will show His Vishnu form. And if you don't want to have anything to give and take with Him, you want relief from suffering, He will put you in Brahman, which is the impersonal light. Correct, no? Even you all sitting here, you relate with different people according to the way others relate with you. Some people intimately deal with you as a friend. You also become heart-to-heart friends with them, correct, no? And some people, like you are one of your friend may just, you know, come into your house, go straight into kitchen and open the fridge and take out the sandwich and put some tomato ketchup and eat and just casually talk to you, correct? Now you have such friends also. And the other friends who would stand at the door and ask you, please may I come in? You have formal relation with them. And there are other guys who are not friends at all with you, who come to only get something done from you. They are not even a friend. They come for, and once that purpose is served, they will go away. Like people work for a company. You know, you ask them, what are you doing? I'm doing service, they say. Oh, really? You're doing service? If the salary stops, the service will stop. Correct, no? But actually for God, we serve voluntarily. Like we people, we live in the temple, we are sadhus, brahmacharis. We serve free. But not only we, Even the visitors to the temple, who are coming to temple, all the grihasthas also, they do seva to the temple. And seva is not charged. But in company you don't do seva. Company you do work, because you need a paycheck. So that is a formal connection. So in your life itself you can see, you have an intimate connection, a formal connection, and only self-serving connection. So similarly, people also relate with God differently. So our movement teaches you to connect with God very intimately. So that you can enter His innermost circle of friends, and like Krishna has mother and father, Granda Baba, Yashoda, His friends like Sita, Masudama, Madhu Mangal, you know, gopis like Radharani, Lalita, Abhishek, all of them, they are all, this is the innermost circle of the spiritual world, which is, actually what I am talking to is a very advanced subject. But if you go from the basics, and you will see it makes a lot of sense. Actually, if there is only a light out there, why should I go there? This world is a better place, isn't it? Yeah. Actually, you desire peace of mind, or you desire loving relationship? Ah, that's true. So therefore, jnanis want peace of mind because they are frustrated with the birth and death in this world. They want to get rid of sufferings. So getting rid of suffering is not the goal of life. In fact, suffering is wonderful in loving relationship. For the loved one, you will take suffering, correct? No? Like your mother, imagine when you were a small kid, you cried in the middle of the night and you woke up your mother. Did your mother slap you? You know, she changed your diaper how many times? Huh? Think about it. So mother doesn't mind the suffering because there is love. It's called as burden of love. Whereas these guys only know one thing, I want to get rid of cycle of birth and death, jnanis. Most organizations teach that. Actually, when I wanted to join an organization, I was planning to join Ramakrishna Mission in 7th standard. My father intelligently told me, don't give your head to anybody until you become an engineer or a doctor, grow in your life and see the world around, go to all organizations, analyze them threadbare, and before entering into any organization, be fully convinced about the philosophy. He was a very, very fine gentleman. He has done a dozen degrees, triple MA in English, maths and all, very learned man. And he told me, although I am the only son and 3 daughters, if you are really convinced to give your life as a brahmachari, I will not become a stumbling block for you. He said, I will give you permission. So then I actually took out time. So in some time I've been going to different organizations, understanding their philosophy, asking questions. At last when I came to ISKCON, I was fully satisfied. Then I settled here. And then I told my father, when I was 25, I told him, and he permitted me at that time. I took their blessings. By the time I settled my sisters and all, married life, everything, then I joined. Now I am 52 now, almost 27 years I've been around, and I found the more I spend the number of years, the more I find it fulfilling, very deeply satisfying, and the philosophy is more and more blossoming. And if you attend these 8 sessions, I told you, you know, we have 2 courses. One is called self-development course. I think they will find it more interesting because it will relate with their corporate life immediately. But the little more advanced than that is discover yourself. I'll give you both links. So you can share with them. If you all go through it, if you're interested, then we can make more association available for you also. Yeah. That was a very brilliant question. It was very nice. You have a question? Yeah, please.
But with all due respect, Prabhuji, and I am also a very big follower of Krishna, but this doesn't end the conflict. This conflict continues. So how do we end the conflict? How do we get peace in any situation where within Hinduism there are so many different streams of
that we
beliefs?
Don't have to worry. See, why we see contradiction? See, I told you that there are different people aiming at different levels. Correct, no? There are different people. Like Brahma Jyoti, jnanis are aiming at. Yogis are aiming at Paramatma and Vishnu form. And the Bhagavan worshippers are aiming at Krishna. So, if you keep aside any personal prejudices and study the Vedas, like even Bhagavad Gita you can study. You can see for yourself. And if you learn little Sanskrit, you know, you can see Bhagavad Gita. And you hear from 4 or 5 different organizations. You hear from them, their version of Bhagavad Gita. And you decide finally. You see for yourself. Like when I read other Gitas, I found that whenever it comes to certain truths that Krishna is speaking, they are sort of slipping out from there. One example I'll tell you. 7.24 Bhagavad Gita. Avyaktam yaktim apannam Manyante mam abuddhayah, Krishna says. You know, people who think that I was impersonal before, and now I have taken a personal form, they are unintelligent people. Very simple Sanskrit. Avyaktam, vyaktim, apannam. The word apannam means obtain. Manyante, jo mante hain, mam, about me, abuddhayah. Even a little child with little knowledge of Sanskrit will understand this. But there are many organizations which say that God is actually impersonal and he has become personal now. So when this verse comes, you see how they translate. They will slip out. They will not be able to explain this. So therefore I am telling you, you have the freedom. Even the students, I tell them, I will not say that you follow me. I will say you go to 5 different organizations, read all their books and see their version of their explanation of the truth. Like one organization says that, you know, if you are born as a dog, you will be again and again dog only. You know, like Brahma Kumaris, they say like that. You know, if you are born as a human, again and again you will be human only. But Bhagavad Gita doesn't say that. I'll quote a verse just now, I'll tell you. Purusha prakritistohi bhungte prakritijan gunan karanam guna sangosya sat asat yoni janmasu. He says that depending on your karma, you will get a sad yoni or a asad yoni. Sad yoni means human body or devata's body. Asad yoni means dogs, cats, insects, reptiles. So Krishna doesn't say that every time you will get human body only. He doesn't say that. So now if you ask them, where are you talking this from? They have some Guruji who has written, you know, in their line something is written, but that is not based on Bhagavad Gita. Therefore, in our organization, you will see that we always emphasize on Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, Vedas, Puranas, Upanishads. In Prabhupada's books, you will find, every 2 pages, you will find a shloka quote. Because we cannot give knowledge. Only God can give knowledge. We can only borrow from God and give it to others, like a postman. We have full faith in his words because his senses are perfect. Our senses are not perfect. God actually is ultimate. He created this world, he's maintaining it. You know, he's maintaining all of us. So his words are final for us. And how do you know the Shastras are his words? Therefore I told you in the middle of the class when that question came, I told that, you know, whatever the words of the Vedas are there are provable, materially observable phenomenon. At least after seeing them, you will develop that, hey, even materially also it is valid. Then spiritually whatever it says is beyond our scope to experiment, but it must be true. If this part is true, we should accept that part also. Correct, no? Is it all right? Yeah. Thank you, ma'am.
Hare Krishna, Prabhupada.
Krishna.
I just have a very basic question. In a very modern context, if you were to speak to a youngster and talk to him about, elaborate on karma.
Yeah.
Good karma, bad karma.
Yeah.
In a very modern world.
Yes.
If you could just elaborate on that.
Very simple. For example, you're walking in the road, you slap a person. Immediately you get a slap. It's called instant karma, we call it. You get a response quickly. Or in case on a party day, midnight, you eat a big pizza, you know, very huge pizza, 2-3 you ate. The next day morning you have, you know, constipation problem, correct? Now you go to the doctor. Of course, if you go to any allopathy doctor, they give you some painkiller to suppress the pain. Any Ayurvedic doctor will ask you, first thing will ask you, your stomach is paining, what did you eat yesterday night? Then he will tell him, then he'll give you some powder to throw it out, you know. So the effect of that eating pizza at night comes after 10 hours or 15 hours. It's a little delayed. Similarly, a student doesn't study well. After 1 year, at the end of the year exams, he performs very poorly. So the results will come after 1 year. Correct, no? Similarly, nowadays many people are earning a lot of money in IT company, but some of them are not saving well. And the IT companies don't give any provident fund or, you know, gratuity and all at the end. Many of the companies don't give. So in which case, what will happen? If you earn in the youth and spend it all, in old days there will be nothing. So the effect of the not saving will be seen after 40, 50 years, towards the fag end of life. That time they will be struggling. Some people work even after 70, isn't it? So that means the effect comes later like that. In the same manner, we all do good and bad in our life. And sometimes certain effects are supposed to come, but before that, our death came. So therefore, the effects of those actions are stored in your mind, in the seed form. And they're taken to the next body. And there they're released. And that is called as a, some people ask why karma is coming in the next life, not in the same life. This is the reason. Like if you throw a ball on the wall, it comes back to you. Similarly, for every action, there has to be a reaction. So they are stored in a seed form. In the next life, they will fructify eventually. Like sometimes you are running and, you know, you are running on the ground, suddenly you fall and get a wound in the knee. Correct, no? Sometimes. How we get that? Because sometimes while running, I mean, we have put our foot on an ant, we caused pain to them, then we get a wound. For every action, there is a reaction. So, in the same manner, if you do Bhagavad Kaikarya, like if you do service to God, you know, that is in God's account. That is a very extraordinary account. That's like if you fight for Kargil war against another neighborhood country, then they will give you Paramvir Chakra, correct, no? But imagine if the same soldier kills his neighbor, he'll be put behind the bars. So, we should not work on our own account, we should work on his account. So, for example, a cashier, you know, collects 20 lakhs, puts in the bank, he gives out 50 lakhs, he doesn't cry, I'm giving 50 lakhs now, because it's not his money. He's giving on account, on bank's account. Similarly, Krishna says, if you work in my account, you will not be victimized. Basically, we have to do as he says. Like he says, you can marry one woman and you can be loyal to her. But if you are having an illicit relation outside her relationship, which I am not allowing, then you will be victimized by sin. Similarly, you can, if you eat vegetarian food, it is called sanctioned food. But still it is sinful because you are killing the plants and everything. But if you offer it to Krishna, it is sanctified. So everything should be sanctioned and sanctified. Like that he says. So in this way, I have one whole this thing on quota. I can show you. It will take just 2 minutes for me to show that. Recently, I made one of the. What is that? Self-reliance. So, yeah, this is the one. See, this is called as, like, what is the meaning of working for Krishna? Working in line with Krishna, if you see. I've shown in 1 month slide, you see here. Vegetarian food offered to God is sanctioned and sanctified. Other side, non-vegetarian, unauthorized foods are not allowed. Similarly, we should not encroach on others' property, knowing that everything belongs to God. Whereas the Kauravas headed by Duryodhana, they were encroaching on Pandava's property. Correct, no? That is sinful. Similarly, honorably earned wealth is perfect. A portion of which is offered to God. If you honorably earned wealth, it is sanctioned. And you offer a portion of that wealth to Krishna service, then it is sanctified also. On the other hand, somebody is earning by lottery. That is earning by wrong means. Sinful. Similarly, if you are doing work that is ordained by God for you, either as teacher or administrator, trader, artisans, like that, that's perfect. But this fellow is, thief who is looting money. So government will not, even Indian government will not allow cheating or thievery as a profession. Will they allow? God also doesn't allow, government also won't allow that, isn't it? Like we say, financial scams, that we say like that. Similarly here you see, that which is not done out of greed for wealth and honor, but in divine consciousness, endeavors, like Arjuna is doing. Whereas this fellow out of greed for wealth and honor is doing many things, many under the table things people do, like bribe and all. Married as per religious principle, that's allowed. Whereas Ravana is taking away another man's wife, that is sinful. Correct, no? Illicit. Similarly, being God-centered and not greedy to increase the prestige. Some people actually possess, dozens and dozens of, like one man in London in Prabhupada's time, Prabhupada is saying that he had 80 rooms in his house. Can you imagine? 80 rooms are huge, but the old man and wife, they were only living in one room only. Hmm? So some people have dozens and dozens of homes and properties to increase prestige and position. But they are not God-centered. That is the main point. Here this family is God-centered family. Remembering that post or position is offered by God. This is, you know who is this? Alfred Ford. He is grandson of Henry Ford. So he is a billionaire. So he is called as a billionaire bhakt. You know, people call him. So he is worshipping Krishna in his house regularly. He is a very good soul. He is a disciple of Srila Prabhupada. So on the other hand, there are people who are indulging in politicking for influence and power. Actually, there are many politicians who do leg pulling, backbiting, and so many things they do. That is not allowed. Similarly, domination, animals should not be slaughtered. This is Parikshit Maharaj protecting the cows. On the other side, you see somebody eating beef. That is prohibited. Similarly, you can sleep six to seven hours to have a healthy body. But some people overeat and keep sleeping during the day like this. That is not allowed. That's prohibited. Oversleeping unnecessarily. Because that actually heats up the body and mind goes crazy. We lose focus and concentration in life. You know, that which is favorable activities like this, we can go for outing, harinam, everything. But watching, you know, cinema magazines and unholy movies that pollute our mind. You know the Gigo principle, you all know Gigo principle? Gigo means good in, good out, garbage in, garbage out. So whatever we put in, if I take garbage in, then garbage will come out of us. Therefore, we should be very careful about intake of what we associate with. To keep body healthy in service of God, doing yogasana is very good. But sometimes people just do sports for attracting the opposite sex or spend time idly, not fulfilling their responsibilities. That is kind of. So like this, now you got an idea, no? So you understand that what is, you know, karma, good karma, bad karma can be understood like this. Is it clear? Yeah, thank you.
There's just one question online. I'd just like to ask you that. How can we work on acceptance of the soul moving on and attachment with the soul who isn't with us physically?
Attachment to that soul who is not with us now because he has left the situation now and gone to the next situation. See, what the scriptures say, why we develop very strong attachment, because whatever you associate with very closely, repeatedly, you develop attachment. Like mother and child relationship also, if you see, mother is bathing the child, dressing the child, decorating the child, sending the child to school, you know. And day in and day out, she is associating. The more you associate with, prolonged exposure leaves impressions. Similarly, the person who lived amidst stress, like Lal Vanaji lived amidst stress, for example. So his speech, his smile, his personality, and the favors he did for us. So these things will occupy our mind. And we should know that the soul who lived some stress is a good soul who came in our family. And we are really fortunate to be with that good soul. But then now the good soul has moved out of this situation to another situation, is going to either another family. So we have to, therefore Lord Krishna tells Arjuna in Bhagavad Gita, once you clearly understand the movement of the soul from one body to another, then you will be at least pacified that, you know, it's not only with him, with all of us, you know. Everybody has to quit the body one day. See, why are we undergoing this turbulence in our life? When we leave, see, here you see the picture of the global mother and father, we call them. When you leave them, we get local mother, father. But the problem with local mother, father is we keep changing local mother, father. Now I have, 3 years ago I lost my mother and father, same year, you know. So in this life I got one mother, father. In my previous life, I was born in another place. There I had another mother, father. So the mother, father keeps changing every century, correct, no? Every 80, 90 years you have to change. And the change is very painful for us, because you are born, you develop attachment, by the time they're gone, then you are painful. Then you go to new situation, you develop new attachment. Even all of you ask yourself a simple question, I'll tell you. See, when you are unmarried, you didn't even know who your wife is, correct, no? But after marriage, within 5 years, you cannot be separated from your wife. You think of her as if you know her for thousands of years. Especially I am talking about thick relationships sometimes between husband and wife. How it happens? Because of association. So therefore what Shastra says, in association develop affection but don't develop attachment, they say. Now Dhritarashtra was attached to Duryodhana or affectionate to Duryodhana? Tell me. He was attached. That's very dangerous, because attachment makes us blind. So attachment is not good, but affection is necessary, because affection is a symptom of soul. So what is the difference between the two? Like if mother is affectionate to a child, she will make the child study, she will let the child play, both. But if a mother is attached to a child, what she will do? Play all day. Beta, I cannot correct you, you know, if I correct you, you will cry, and that I cannot tolerate. Some mothers are too permissive. Actually, too permissive is also very dangerous. Child will become spoiled also. And there are some mothers who are too rigid also, too strict also, authoritarian. Neither of it is good. Combine both the things, polite and firm. So therefore affectionate relationship is good. So if you are attached, some people actually, if somebody dies, they will not eat food, and 15 days they will not speak to anybody, they can't cry also. Some people get shock, heavy shock, because they have not yet started understanding spiritual life. I would say that whoever is asking the question, I'll tell them, please read the Bhagavad Gita from today. Everybody read one shloka and go through the verses. By the end of Gita, you'll be very enlightened. Arjuna was also weeping in the beginning of the Gita. At the end of Gita, he was cheerful and he took his bow and arrow and fought a valiant battle and emerged victorious. So he was no more sobbing. Because it's like change of dress. When you change dress every day, do you cry? Like now you're all wearing one dress. Tomorrow you will change your dress. You will not cry. Similarly, death is only change of dress for the soul. Vasam sijirnani yata vihaya navani grihnati naro parani tata sharirani vihaya jirnani anyani samyati navani dehi. Krishna says this. When this body becomes jirna, then you accept another body. Like some people's body, I've seen, one fellow was 88. Doctors were saying that he had cancer also, he was bedridden. So suddenly his kidney failed, then his heart failed, then his brain failed, then lungs failed, you know. Then the doctor said multiple organ failure. Do you think the soul can reside in that body anymore? Then the soul left the body. But then you will get a child's body now. Now again a healthy body. Then he will continue in that body. Because the body gets worn out like a machine. You have to leave this body. Even all of you sitting here, do you all agree that you have some health complication which you only know about your body? Correct? Now we all know. Some people have stomach problems, some people have lung problems, some people have heart problem, some people have kidney problem. Everybody's body has some problem. Is there anybody here who can say that, Prabhu, I never even got a headache in my life. I had the healthiest body from my birth up to now. I never got sick. Any of you can say that? Can anybody say that? So that's the way the material body is. Material body is a vehicle given to the soul. Shariram kaludharma sadhanam. It's a dharma sadhan. We should use this body to do spiritual activities and use it as a springboard to go back to Godhead. Never be born again. That is real sign of intelligence. Otherwise, we use this body to do wrong activities and we are coming again and again in this world. Good, thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Mera naam Ratna hai. Can I put my question in Hindi?
Oh, any language. So, I know.
थोड़ा सा मेरा क्वेश्चन है कि एक हिंदू सनातन धर्म में कॉन्सेप्ट है 84 लाख योनियों वाला, कि हमको 84 लाख योनियों में से मानव जन्म एक ही बार मिलता है.
उसमें 400,000 4 लाख योनियां है मानव में.
आई वॉन्ट टू फिनिश माई क्वेश्चन. सो बहुत दुर्लभ है ये मानव जीवन, और इसी में हम साधना कर सकते हैं और जन्म मरण के बंधन से छूट सकते हैं.
करेक्ट.
और गीता जी में श्री कृष्ण भगवान ने हमको अश्योर किया है कि यदि हम अच्छे कर्म करते हैं तो अच्छे बुरे दोनों ही कर्म होते हैं, पर हमारे अच्छे कर्म बाकी हैं तो हम रॉयल फैमिलीज में, इंटेलेक्चुअल फैमिलीज में जन्म लेते हैं.
Correct.
और अपने सत्कर्मों का फल भोगते हैं.
करेक्ट.
और अगर हमारे लो कैटेगरी वाले कर्म बाकी हैं तो हम लो कैटेगरी फैमिलीज में जन्म लेते हैं और दुख भोगते हैं. तो गीता जी के हिसाब से हम मतलब मनुष्य जन्म में बार बार आ सकते हैं.
Correct.
अपने कर्मों के हिसाब से.
Correct.
तो दोनों कॉन्सेप्ट में से क्या सही है? 84 लाख योनियों में एक बार मानव जन्म या कर्म कर्मों के हिसाब से
बार बार भी मनुष्य जन्म मिल सकता है, बार बार भी मिल सकता है, लेकिन भगवान बताते हैं गीता में ऊर्ध्वं गच्छन्ति सत्त्वस्था मध्ये तिष्ठन्ति राजसा जगन्यगुण वृत्तिस्था अधो गच्छन्ति तामसा। बताते हैं भगवान कि अगर कोई मांस खाता है, ये सर की चीजों खाता है, तो उसको नीचे वो नहीं मिलते हैं, जैसे बाघ शेर ऐसे शरीर मिलते हैं उसको। अगर कोई स्त्रियों के साथ गलत व्यवहार करता है, अवैध संग करता है, तो उसको कुत्ते जैसे जन्म भी मिल सकता है उसको। अगर कोई इस दुनिया में रहते समय पुण्य कर्म करता है, नहीं तो उसने पाप नहीं किया है, अच्छा जीवन जिया है, तो उसको वापस उसके अंदर अनेक इच्छाएं हैं, इच्छा की पूर्ति के लिए वापस मनुष्य जन्म लेगा वो, ऐसे भी होता है। ऐसे अगर किसी ने कुछ वैदिक अनुष्ठानों को अपनाया है, पुण्य कर्म किया है, तो उसको स्वर्गवास प्राप्त होता है। स्वर्ग में भी अनेक लोग हैं, जैसे किन्नर हैं, गंधर्व हैं, चारण हैं, अनेक तरह के लोग हैं, स्वर्ग लोक में उसको मिलता है। लेकिन अगर किसी ने भगवान की कैंकर्य किया हो, उसको भक्ति सुकृति प्राप्त होता है। भगवान बोलते हैं कि मेरे लीलाओं को जो दिव्य दिव्य समझेगा, वो इस दुनिया में पुनः पुनर्जन्म नहीं लेगा वो। जैसे भगवान ने दोनों लीला किया है, अलौकिक लौकिक, जैसे उदाहरण के लिए गोचरण लीला भगवान करते हैं, हम भी गोचरण कर सकते हैं, माखन चोरी की लीला हम भी कर सकते हैं, लेकिन भगवान ने गोवर्धन पर्वत को उठाया और दावानल अग्नि को पिया, तो इस तरह दोनों लीला किया उन्होंने। इसलिए अगर कोई इन लीलाओं को पढ़कर समझकर भगवान के ऊपर अटूट विश्वास बैठ गया उनको, तो वो लोगों को मृत्यु के बाद इस दुनिया में पुनर्जन्म नहीं मिलेगा, वो भगवान के धाम में लौट जाएंगे, क्योंकि भगवान के धाम में नित्य निरंतर उनका शाश्वत संग प्राप्त होगा जीव को। ऐसे नित्य लीला में जुड़ जाते हैं वो ऐसे। तो जैसे आपने बोला कि एक बार मनुष्य जन्म मिला है हमको, अगर आप अच्छा करते हैं तो और एक बार मिलेगा आपको। कब तक मिलता रहेगा मनुष्य जन्म हमको? जब तक हम पाप नहीं करते हैं, पुण्य करते जाते हैं, तो अगले बार बार जन्म लेकर वो पुण्य को काटने के लिए भी हम आते हैं। लेकिन पुण्य पाप दोनों से भी बढ़कर ऊपर है आध्यात्मिक कर्म, जैसे मैं बता रहा था, नाम जप करना, गीता पढ़ना, संत महात्मा का संग करना, और भगवान की पूजा आराधना करना इत्यादि, और इस तरह कृष्ण की सेवा में जुड़ना, तो उन लोगों को कर्म दिव्य बन जाता है। जैसे उनके क्वेश्चन में उदाहरण दिया मैंने, अगर एक सैनिक भारत के लिए युद्ध करता है तो उसको परम चक्र मिलता है, लेकिन खुद के अकाउंट में काम करता तो उसको लाभ नुकसान दोनों होगा उसको। भगवान बोलते हैं कि तुम्हारा प्रॉफिट लॉस अकाउंट में मत पढ़ो, तुम मेरे आदेश अनुसार तुम चलाओ। अभी मैंने अभी आपको दोनों दिखाया, क्या सही कर्म है क्या गलत कर्म है, तो हम गलत कर्म को तो छोड़ना ही चाहिए हमको, लेकिन सही कर्म में भी दो तरीके के हैं, एक है सैंक्शनड, दूसरा है सैंक्शनड एंड सैंक्टिफाइड। सैंक्शन एंड सैंक्टिफाइड, उसका मतलब भाई वेजिटेरियन खाना, एक व्यक्ति बोला प्रभुपाद जी को, स्वामी जी मैं वेजिटेरियन हूँ, बोला प्रभुपाद पर ये क्या बड़ी बात है, बंदर भी वेजिटेरियन है, ऐसे बोले प्रभुपाद जी। हाँ, सात्विक खाना भी वेजिटेरियन है, नहीं बंदर भी ऐसे ही खाता, सात्विक खाता, वो भी फल का ही खाता। प्रभुपाद क्या बोले, सात्विक खाना भरपूर नहीं है, भगवान को भोग चढ़ाकर खाना चाहिए, इसलिए वी आर नॉट वेजिटेरियन, वी आर कृष्णटेरियन, ऐसे बोले वो। इस तरह हम लोग अगर कोई बोलता है प्रभु जी मैं सज्जन हूँ, मैं घूस नहीं लेता हूँ, कंपनी में जो पैसा लेता हूँ उसको ही खर्चा करता हूँ, वो सज्जन है, उसको पाप नहीं लगेगा। लेकिन अगर वो भगवान को थोड़ा 5% अर्पित करता है, वो दिव्य बनता है उसका पैसा। जैसे कंपनी में TDS बोलते हैं ना, टैक्स डिडक्टेड एट सोर्स, इस तरह भगवान के लिए भी दूसरा है, ट्रांसेंडेंटल डिवोशनल सर्विस, वो दूसरा TDS है, वो जब करेगा तब वो पैसा दिव्य बनेगा। अभी कोई पूछेगा भगवान के लिए क्यों करना चाहिए मुझे, अभी सूर्य का ताप हम ले रहे हैं, पानी जो बरसा रहे हैं भगवान ले रहे हैं, प्रकृति से कितना ले रहे हैं हम, भगवान के लिए क्या करने सोचना चाहिए, तो इस तरह हमारे कर्मों को दिव्य बनाना चाहिए हमें। पहले तो अनुमति जिन चीज़ों को दिया गया है उसको ही करना चाहिए, और उसको भी दिव्य बनाएंगे तो लाभ और ज़्यादा है। आपने दोनों का फर्क समझा ना आपने, करेक्ट।
थैंक यू।
84 लाख में इधर ही घूमते रहते हैं उसके अंदर, लेकिन दिव्य कर्म बनने से उससे ऊपर उठ जाते हैं, दिव्य कर्म भक्ति की, भक्ति सुकृति।
उसका है बर्थ का जो कॉन्सेप्ट है वो थोड़ा डराने वाला है।
हाँ करेक्ट,
कि उसके कारण, उस डर के कारण इंसान अच्छा कर्म करता है और कोशिश करता है कि मैं जन्म मरण के बंधन से छूटने की कोशिश करूं, ऐसे कर्म करूं।
करेक्ट करेक्ट।
वो एक डराने वाला है, लेकिन गीता में जो कृष्ण भगवान ने कहा है वो डराता नहीं है, अच्छे कर्म करने के लिए प्रेरित करता है।
करेक्ट करेक्ट।
सत्कर्म करनी।
और भगवान गीता में बताते हैं कि यान्ति देवव्रता देवान् पितुम यान्ति पितुव्रताः भूतानि यान्ति भूतेज्या यान्ति मत्याजिनोऽपि माम। क्या बताते हैं? अगर तुम भूतों प्रेतों का पूजा करेंगे तो उधर उनके पास जाओगे, देवताओं के करेंगे तो उनके पास जाओगे तुम, लेकिन मेरा पूजा करेंगे तो मेरे पास आओगे, भगवान इसे बताते हैं। इसलिए भगवान को केंद्र उदाहरण देता हूँ आपको, अन्नदान अगर आप देते हो, अन्नदान देते हैं तो अगले जन्म में आपको अन्न की कभी कमी नहीं पड़ेगा, है आपके पास बहुत केतियाँ रहेंगे, अन्न मिलता जाएगा आपको। लेकिन अगर आप अन्नदान देते समय भगवान को भोग चढ़ा कर खिलाएंगे तो प्रसाद हो गया वो, तो प्रसाद देने के कारण आपको भगवत प्राप्ति हो जाएगा, आपको वैकुंठ चले जाएंगे और उधर भगवान के साथ आप अन्न खाएंगे, भगवान के साथ बैठकर। लेकिन जो लोग सिर्फ अन्नदान देते हैं वो दिव्य नहीं है लेकिन पुण्य है, वो उसको भौतिक पुण्य बोलते हैं उसको। तो अनेक लोग भारत में भौतिक पुण्य करते हैं लेकिन भक्ति भाव में प्रेम के द्वारा जुड़ते नहीं भगवान से। तो वो गीता में भगवान बोलते हैं कि जो मेरे पास जुड़ गए हैं भक्ति में वो पुण्य कर्म करने वालों से भी श्रेष्ठ है। यू अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस? यस मैम।
प्रभु जी, किसी ने ऑनलाइन पूछा है, ये मेरी कजिन ने पूछा है कि वेरी फ्यू पीपल हैव द काइंड ऑफ भक्ति दैट माई फादर हैड, एंड इज दैट डेस्टिनी और कैन यू नो समबडी वर्क टूवर्ड्स इट?
हाँ, वी कैन वर्क टूवर्ड्स इट ऑल्सो। इसमें हमको हमारे अभ्यास के ऊपर है। देखिए, भगवान ने हमको दोनों दिया, फेट एंड फ्री विल। फेट का मतलब तकदीर, फ्री विल का मतलब स्वतंत्र इच्छा। जैसे मान लीजिए इधर एक अगर गाय है, इतना रस्सी दिया है, ये गाय है, इधर बांध कर रखा, नया नया गाय लाया हूँ मैं मार्केट से, इसे बांध कर रखा है मैं। अभी किसान क्या करेगा, उसको बांध कर देखेगा कैसे बिहेव करता है गाय, है कि नहीं? सो दिस इज द फेट ऑफ द काउ। इसका फेट ऐसा है क्योंकि अभी इसके बाहर नहीं जा सकता, वो उसका फेट है। इसका फ्री विल क्या है, इसके अंदर इतना घूम सकता है, घास खा सकता है इतना, वो उसका फ्री विल है। अभी इसका फ्री विल को बढ़ाना हो तो गाय को क्या करना पड़ेगा, किसान को दिखाना पड़ेगा कि मैं सही ढंग से व्यवहार करूँगा। कुछ गाय एकदम शांत रहते हैं, जो घास देता खाते हैं, भूसा खाते हैं, शांत रहते हैं और सबके साथ अच्छा व्यवहार करते हैं। कोई जाकर उसको ऐसे करते हैं फिर भी काम रहता है वो एकदम शांत। तो किसान सोचता है कि अच्छा गाय है, नया नया गाय है फिर भी अच्छा है, तो उसका लंबा उसका रस्सी जो है उसको और बड़ा करेगा, उसको कम करेगा, क्या करेगा, बड़ा करेगा, क्योंकि अच्छा बिहेव किया। कुछ गाय है निकट जाएंगे, नए नए गाय ऐसे करेगा, ऐसे देखा आपने, ऐसे अपने सींग को दिखाएगा, तो किसान क्या सोचेगा, अरे बच्चे निकट जाएंगे तो बड़ा खतरनाक है, तो क्या करेगा वो, रस्सी का बढ़ाएगा कम करेगा, कम करेगा। दैट मीन्स नो, अगर हमारा फेट तकदीर को हमारा स्वतंत्रता घट जाता है जब हम उसका दुष्प्रयोग करते हैं, उसका सदुपयोग करते हैं तो फ्री विल बढ़ जाता है। और दूसरा उदाहरण, एक छोटा लड़का, अभी माता पिता बच्चे को थोड़ा पैसा देते हैं, 5 रुपया, अगर बच्चा 5 रुपये लेकर सिगरेट फूंकता है 5वीं कक्षा में तो पैसा देना बंद ही कर देंगे वो, लेकिन अगर उसका सदुपयोग करता है तो धीरे धीरे बोलेंगे कि बच्चा अच्छा है, वो कुछ बोले बिना करता नहीं है, उसको बीरो का चाबी दे देंगे, बोलेंगे बेटा चब चाहिए ले लो, बड़े होने के बाद एक अकाउंट भी खोल देंगे उसके नाम में, और भी बड़े होने के बाद देखेंगे जिम्मेदार बन गया, विवाह हो गया इसका, सेटल हो गया, अभी अच्छा देख रहा है, सज्जन है, पूरा अपने पैसा को उसके नाम में लिख देंगे, करेक्ट है ना? उसका फ्रीडम आउट बढ़ता जा रहा है उसका, लेकिन जो दुष्प्रयोग किया उसका फ्रीडम घटता है। इस तरह भगवान एकदम रिजिड आदमी नहीं है, वो देखते हैं कि जीव अपने फ्री विल को कैसे इस्तेमाल कर रहा है, उसके अनुसार भगवान उसको बढ़ाएंगे नहीं तो घटेंगे, ऐसे करेंगे।
और उस दिन आपने द अदर डे आपने बताया था कि एक डिवोटी का जो 40% अगर वो डिवोशन ये बर्थ में करता है तो
अगले जन्म 41 से चालू होगा।
हाँ
करेक्ट। और पूर्व जन्म में क्या हुआ, पूर्व जन्म अर्जित पुण्यम अग्रे दावती दावती, शास्त्र बताते हैं कि अगर आपने 20-25 किया हो पूर्व जन्म में तो अभी जिधर छोड़ा आपने उधर से चालू होता है, कंटिन्यू करते हैं। मुझे तो लग रहा है कि लालवानी जी ने बहुत किया होगा पहले भी, क्योंकि देखिए मंदिर में औपचारिक पूजा करके जाने वाले बहुत लोग हैं। हम देखते हैं भारत में तो कहीं भी मंदिर को लोग भीड़ आ जाएगा, लोगों को भगवान की श्रद्धा है, जरूर आते हैं, लेकिन भगवान को प्रेम से देखना और उनके लिए सेवा में जुड़ना, और जब मंदिर को लॉकडाउन में लॉक करके रखते हैं तब इच्छा करना, अपेक्षा करना कि मुझे दर्शन मिले, तो ज़रूर ऐसे लोगों ने बहुत किया होगा पहले, बिकॉज दैट टाइप ऑफ, इसलिए मैं आपको पूछा कि इंटीमेट रिलेशनशिप, फॉर्मल रिलेशनशिप एंड नो रिलेशनशिप, तीन स्तर होता है अभिज्ञानियों का, योगियों का, भक्तों का. भक्तों का इंटीमेट होता है भगवान के साथ, एंड इट इज़ नॉट दैट वी कैन नॉट डेवलप इट इन दिस लाइफ ऑल्सो. जैसे अगर आप बिजनेस में टाइम इन्वेस्ट करते हो उतना बिजनेस भी बढ़ता है ना, इसी तरह भक्ति में भी जो टाइम इन्वेस्ट करता है, भगवान को हमें दिखाना चाहिए कि मैं इतना सीरियस हूँ आपको प्राप्त करने के लिए, आपने जो बोला मत करो हम नहीं करेंगे, आपने जो बोला करो हम करेंगे, तो इस तरह इससे भगवान का हृदय भी पिघल जाएगा. और भक्ति में हमें एक ही जन्म में भी कोई बैक टू गॉड जा सकता है. प्रॉपर राइट्स इन वन प्लेस, इन वन लाइफ टाइम ऑल्सो वी कैन गो बैक. इवन अ हाउस वाइफ कुकिंग इन द किचन, ऑफरिंग भोगा, बविंग डाउन टू लॉर्ड, नाम जप करती है रेगुलर, उसी जन्म में जा सकते हो फेथफुल इफ शी इज डूइंग विदाउट डैमेजिंग हर यू नो गुड कैरियर बाई अदर अनवॉन्टेड थिंग्स. सो एक्चुअली वी हैव टू नो वॉट टू डू एंड वी हैव टू स्टिक टू इट. Yeah.
मेरे पास और टू थ्री क्वेश्चंस हैं, इफ यू डोंट माइंड. तो एक्सटेंडिंग ऑन माय कजिन्स क्वेश्चन, निखिल का क्वेश्चन, कि जो कॉन्फ्लिक्ट होता है ये रिलीजन के, जो क्योंकि क्या होता है बहुत डिविजिव हो गया है आजकल, तो वो कॉन्फ्लिक्ट कैसे रिड्यूस करें, मतलब अगर उसको कम करना है कि कॉन्वर्जेशन में नहीं पढ़ना है, आपको पता है कि आप किस में बिलीव करते हैं, हमको पता है हम किस में करते हैं, वो कॉन्फ्लिक्ट कम करने के लिए क्या कर सकते हैं.
एक्चुअली कॉन्फ्लिक्ट कम करने के लिए पहला उपाय, सरल उपाय है, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड अदर्स फर्स्ट एंड देन सीक टू बी अंडरस्टूड. हमें क्या करना चाहिए, हमारा बड़ा समस्या, भगवान ने दो कान दिया है एक मुंह दिया है ताकि हम अच्छे सुने दूसरों को, लेकिन हम क्या करते हैं, सुन नहीं पाते हैं. दोनों सोचते हैं कि तुम मेरा सुनो, ये बोलते हैं तुम मेरा सुनो, ऐसे ताली इससे ही आवाज उठता है. अगर एक व्यक्ति नम्र होकर सुनने के लिए तैयार हो तो मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग सब निकल जाएगा. आप लोग जानते हैं, एक मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग उदाहरण देता हूँ मैं आपको. एक वाली और सुग्रीव दोनों भाई भाई थे. अभी वाली का क्या हुआ, वाली बड़ा बलशाली था, बड़ा भाई था ना वो. एक बार एक असुर के साथ उसका युद्ध हुआ, तो ऐसे युद्ध करते करते तो वो गुफा के अंदर घुस गए वो लोग. तो बाहर छोटा भाई खड़ा था सुग्रीव, लेकिन अंदर से बड़ा आवाज निकला ओ करके. सोचा कि वाली मर गया, असुर ने मार दिया उसको, अभी बाहर आकर मुझे भी मारेगा. अगर दोनों भाई हम मर गए तो शासन कौन करेगा. इस तरह सोचकर उन्होंने वो दरवाजा को बंद कर दिया एक चट्टान को लेकर, और रोते हुए वापस लौट गया सुग्रीव. जाकर बोला मिनिस्टर लोगों को, मेरा भाई मर गया, इस तरह उधर से खून बह रहा था देखा मैंने. तो वो लोगों ने बोला ठीक है, वाली तो मर गया, तुम अभी तुम आप राजा बनो, किसी न किसी को तो संभालना पड़ेगा. तो राजा बना वो. अभी कुछ दिनों के बाद वाली, वो वाली बरा नहीं था, वाली ने उसको मारा था, और वो ऐसे लात मारकर चट्टान को तोड़ दिया, वो बाहर आ गया. सीधा भागते हुए गया कि मेरे भाई ने मुझे बंद करके मारने के लिए योजना की है. इसे सोचते हुए जाकर उसको पकड़ कर मारने के लिए गया. अब सुग्रीव ने बोला भैया भैया सुनो, एक्चुअली क्या हुआ मैं बताऊंगा. वो बोला पहले तुमको मारूंगा उसके बाद सुनूंगा. सुनने के लिए तह नहीं था वो. पीछे पड़ा वो ऋषिमुख पर्वत में जाकर छुप गया वो. आप लोग कथा जानते हैं रामायण में क्या हुआ. तो बोलने का मतलब क्या, अगर वाली सुनता था ना तो वाली राजा बन सकता था, क्योंकि सुग्रीव तो राज्य पदवी देने के लिए तैयार था, वो उसके अनुपस्थिति में लिया था उसने है? लेकिन इसी तरह अंडरस्टैंडिंग करने के लिए दोनों तैयार नहीं है. कभी कभी आप लोगों ने ये सुना है, हमने LKG में पढ़ा था एक कहानी, दो बकरी आते हैं ऐसे एक पुल के ऊपर, तो ये बोलता अर्जेंट बोलता है, ये बोलता सुपर अर्जेंट बोलता है, दोनों को अर्जेंट है. दोनों ऐसे झगड़ा करके क्या होता है, पानी में गिर जाते हैं. अभी दूसरा कहानी क्या बोलते हैं, दोनों आते हैं, ये बोलता अर्जेंट सुपर अर्जेंट, ये बोलता ठीक है मैं बैठता हूँ तुम ऊपर चले जाओ, तो उसके ऊपर चढ़कर चला जाता हो, और ये भी उठकर चला जाता, दोनों का काम हो जाता है थोड़ा दो मिनट वेट करने से. अभी ये कहानी बच्चों को सिखाते हैं, बड़ों को सिखाना चाहिए हा? क्योंकि LKG में पढ़कर क्या समझेंगे बच्चे हैं, कॉलेज जाने के बाद ये सब सुनते नहीं. तो हम लोग को एडजस्ट करके चलने के लिए, बेंड होने के लिए सीखना चाहिए, फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी. सी देर आर सर्टन फाइन क्वालिटीज हमें कल्टिवेट करना चाहिए, जैसे ह्यूमिलिटी, टॉलरेंस, रेस्पेक्टिंग अदर्स ओपिनियंस, willingness to listen to others, understanding first before speaking, not judging others, forgetting the past and forgiving. So इस तरह की क्वालिटी सीखना चाहिए. भूतकाल को भूल जाने का अभी आगे देखेंगे हम. अगर तुमने पहले जो गलती किया मैं भूल जाऊंगा, अभी आगे देखेंगे किस तरह वापस नहीं होता, माफ कर देने की सहनशीलता, नम्रता और दूसरों की मत को भी आदर देना। एक उदाहरण देता हूँ, मुंबई में श्रीनाथ जी प्रभु के सीमा बल्ब्स के ओनर हैं, उनके पास बड़ा फार्म है कारला ऐसे एक स्थान में। तो परमपूज राजनाथ महाराज के कमरे में आए थे वो, तो महाराज ने उनको पूछा, हम एक आपके फार्म में एक प्रोग्राम रखना चाहते हैं हमारे 200 लीडर्स के साथ, कर सकते हैं क्या? वो बोले महाराज को, महाराज एक मिनट में आता हूँ। तो बाहर गए, एक फ़ोन करके वापस आए, बोले ऐसे महाराज कर सकते हैं हम कार्यक्रम। बाहर ने बोला किसको फ़ोन किया आपने? तो वो बोले कि मेरे पत्नी से पूछ लेना चाहिए क्योंकि वो ही फार्म को देखती है, हा? वो हमारे शी इज़ लाइक ए लीडर एट होम है, मैं उनको पूछे बिना कुछ नहीं करता। महाराज इतने खुश हो गए उनसे, उस दिन संडे फीस क्लास में भी बोल दिया महाराज ने, ना जी देखिए इतने बड़े इंडस्ट्रियलिस्ट हैं, अपने पत्नी को भी अपने डिसीजन मेकिंग में इन्वॉल्व करता है, ऐसे बोला महाराज ने। जो इस तरह हम लोग जिनके साथ कॉन्फ्लिक्ट होता है उनको इन्वॉल्व करते हैं डिसीजन मेकिंग में, तब धीरे धीरे संबंध जुड़ जाएगा। वी शुड बी इन्वॉल्विंग दैम एंड ऑल्सो दिस क्वालिटीज कम बाई चैंटिंग हरे कृष्णा। अभी जिसके पास धैर्य नहीं है, नाम जप कीजिए धैर्य आ जाएगा, नम्रता आएगा, सब सद्गुण आएगा। एंड ऑल्सो वी हैव अ होल सेमिनार ऑन कॉन्फ्लिक्ट रेजोल्यूशन ऑल्सो, वी कैन ऑल्सो लिसन, देर आर मेनी अदर फैक्टर्स, आई टोल्ड यू द बेसिक थिंग्स। मेनी टाइम्स द कॉन्फ्लिक्ट इज ऑन द ईगोइस्टिक प्लेटफॉर्म, अहंकार के तर पर होता है। अनेक बार दोनों एक ही चीज़ को बोल रहे हैं, थोड़ा स्लाइटली डिफरेंट बोल रहे हैं, हाँ ऐसे, लेकिन अहंकार में चोट पहुँच गया तो वो, आप उसको पूछिए तुम्हारा मत क्या है, वो क्या बोलेगा, तुम जो बोलने वाले हो उसके विरुद्ध है, ऐसे बोलेगा, है ना, या अहंकार के इस पर होता है ऐसे। दोनों, बोथ ऑफ देम गेट इन टू प्रूविंग मोड, नॉट इन इम्प्रूविंग मोड। सो शुड वी इम्प्रूव और प्रूव?
Improve.
So if both parties say we will improve, is there fight? No. And can we say that I have no more scope to improve, I am already perfect? All of us have deficiency. Actually, भगवान के समक्ष आते समय हम एकदम समझेंगे हम कितने छोटे हैं। Actually, बड़ों को सर झुकना, भगवान के सामने सर झुकना, ये जब तक हम रेगुलर रूप से नहीं करेंगे, इस तरह के अच्छे गुण नहीं आएगा आसानी से।
और एक और क्वेश्चन था कि ऐसे बहुत लोग पूछते हैं कि अगर कृष्णा ही विष्णु है और राम है, बुद्धा है, तो हम कृष्णा को ही क्यों वर्शिप करते हैं, बाकी सबको क्यों नहीं करते?
एक्चुअली जैसे मैंने बताया, प्रधानमंत्री घर में, प्रधानमंत्री पार्लियामेंट में, अभी पार्लियामेंट में उनका संबंध एकदम फॉर्मल है, विष्णु का संबंध ऐसा है, विष्णु एंड डिवोटीज आर वेरी फॉर्मल। आपने कभी देखा है हनुमान प्रभु रामचंद्र के कंधे के ऊपर चढ़ते हैं? कभी देखा आपने प्रभु रामचंद्र इनके कंधे के ऊपर चढ़ते हैं, हनुमान के एक कंधे में हनुमान, ये रामचंद्र है, दूसरे कंधे में लक्ष्मण, आपने देखा होगा। लेकिन कभी आपने देखा हनुमान चढ़ते हैं भगवान के ऊपर? वो आलिंगन देते हैं, भगवान देते हैं उनको, उसको भी संकोच करते हैं वो हनुमान जी। लेकिन कृष्ण के गोप मित्र जो होते हैं श्रीदामा सुधा मधुमंगल, कभी कृष्ण भी हार जाते हैं उनके खेल में, तब वो भगवान उनको अपने कंधे के ऊपर लेके जाकर वो खेल में करते हैं, भगवान ऐसी सेवा करते हैं, क्योंकि वो लोग भगवत्ता को देखते नहीं, दे डील विथ हिम ओनली लाइक अ फ्रेंड ऐसे। लेकिन राम, सीताराम और लक्ष्मी नारायण के संबंध में प्रभुत्व, प्रभु भगवान को ईश्वर के मैं मानना, उसमें ऐश्वर्य भाव ज़्यादा है। हम लोग सीताराम का भी पूजा करते हैं, आप देखेंगे हमारे जुहू मंदिर में है, वे भी है, दिल्ली में भी है सीताराम लक्ष्मण हनुमान, ऐसे हमें पुणे में बालाजी भी है, पुणे में बालाजी नारायण ही है विष्णु, वी हैव वी वर्शिप ऑल द थ्री डेटीज। या
और एक क्वेश्चन ये था कि हमको अभी पता है भगवद गीता, हम इतने दिन से सुन रहे हैं इसके बारे में, सब बोल रहे हैं कि अर्जुन का स्टेट भी बिगनिंग में कैसा था, वैसा अभी हमारा स्टेट है, और हमको आंसर्स मिलेंगे भगवद गीता में, और हमको पता पड़ेगा कैसे सोल की जर्नी होती है और कैसे हम कृष्णा से क्लोज हो सकते हैं। पर फिर भी अगर आप देखिए महाभारत में अर्जुन जब
रो पड़े अगर, एक्चुअली वो कुछ समय के लिए रोया उन्होंने, बाद में उठकर अपने कर्तव्य परायण हो गए वो उसके बाद, इसलिए आपको कम से कम 2-3 महीना लगेगा, वो स्मरण आएगा, बार बार स्मरण आता रहेगा इसका। हम लोग अपने कर्तव्यों को करते जाना चाहिए। और जैसे मैंने आपको पिछले बार आते समय बताया, मैंने हम ये बात समझना चाहिए कि कैसे उस व्यक्ति ने अमरत्व को पाया है। वो असली रूप में देखा जाए तो वो अमर है, क्योंकि आत्मा अमर है, अजर है, शरीर अशाश्वत है। तो इस बात के ऊपर समझने से हमें देखना चाहिए कि ये भगवान के निकट हैं, अभी भगवान के साथ हैं, भगवान ही इनके शुभ चिंतक हैं और इनके मार्गदर्शक हैं। अभी पहले हम लोग इनको सुझाव दे सकते थे, अगर इनका तबीयत थोड़ा ठीक नहीं तो आप बोलते थे एक दवाई का आइए, वो डॉक्टर के पास जाइए, लेकिन अभी हमारे हाथ से निकल गए तो अभी भगवान की सुरक्षा में है वो। इस तरह देखने से हमें चिंता नहीं होगा। देखिए कब हमें चिंता ज़्यादा होता है, पता नहीं चले गए किधर गए होंगे, पता नहीं अभी उनको कौन ध्यान देगा, उनके ऊपर अटेंशन कौन देगा। कुछ लोग बहुत इसके बारे में चिंता करते हैं, लेकिन जब हम भगवान की भक्ति में आगे बढ़ते हैं हम समझ जाएंगे कि वो भगवान के सुरक्षित अवस्था में है उनके साथ।
एंड ये लॉस को मतलब इससे डील करने के लिए हम भगवान की भक्ति,
हाँ एक्चुअली आप भगवान की भजन सुनिए, कीर्तन सुनिए, मंदिर में जाइए, आपको समय को खाली समय मत छोड़िए। थोड़ा भी टाइम खाली रहेगा ना तुरंत मन इधर ही जाएगा। एंड ऑल्सो सम चेंज ऑफ प्लेस विल ऑल्सो हेल्प। जिस स्थान में आप रहे हैं उसी स्थान में आप अगर आने वाले 2-3-4-5 महीना आप रहते हैं तो स्मरण बहुत आता है। जैसे अगर एक स्थान में एक ही कमरे में थे वो, उसी कमरे में बहुत बातचीत हुआ है, अनेक बार आदान प्रदान इत्यादि हुआ है, तो स्मरण ज़्यादा आता है उसमें। फॉर अ चेंज यू गो, यू गो टू अनदर प्लेस फॉर सम टाइम एंड स्पेंड टाइम एंड डोंट कीप एम्प्टी आइडल टाइम। Keep yourself spiritually very nicely engaged, yeah. Positively engaged. हाँ, उनका भी है। हाँ, बोलिए।
Prabhu ji, I'm Bhagwan Rajkumar's brother. What is your opinion about a person who's very religious? He does his prayers regularly, but eats non-veg. Drinks occasionally.
He is non-veg and what else he does?
Drinks, alcohol, drinks. Occasionally. But he is a religious guy and he is praying regularly. And karmas are good, other karmas are good. But yeah. He is eating non-veg and...
Actually, he may be eating non-veg because he is not aware that in the body of the goat or the chicken also, you know, Atma is present. Correct, no? Once you learn that same Atma is present, in the animal body, bird's body. For example, you know, we don't kill a human being. Why? Because there's a life in human body, Atma is present. Same way with, you know, chicken or goat or cow. You know? In all these bodies, you know, Pandita Samadarshana, it is said, you should see them all equally. I'll ask you a simple question. Say, I'm going in a truck. Somebody is going in a Luna. Just because Luna is small, can I hit it with my truck? Can I do that? Can I hit him and kick him on the side? Can I do that? Just because, see, Luna driver and the truck driver, both are same in quality, correct? No, both are human beings. In the same manner, Atma is same in quality. Even when we kill an ant, they feel a lot of pain. So you think about the meat that one eats, you know. When we are cutting the animal will feel tremendous suffering. So what Lord Krishna says in Gita, just for the pleasure of your tongue, why do you have to kill others? Amongst the killing, human killing is the worst. Our next worst killing is animals. Then the plants, generally you don't have to kill them. You can take the vegetables. If you don't touch vegetables, they will fall on its own. You can take vegetables, fruits. But sometimes we kill the plants, like our shark and all we kill. Plants. But when you kill plants also, there is sin. But Krishna says, if you offer it to me, then I take away the sin. But Krishna doesn't say, you can offer the meat to me or eggs to me. He doesn't say that. So, because that food is unoffered food, even though he's a religious person, he may be going to temple, but he's eating meat and is drinking. Now, why is drinking bad, I will tell you. When a person drinks, he is not in his normal state. He becomes angry sometimes. He beats up somebody sometimes. And also, some people say, can't we drink moderately? But you can't be moderate. You will see that initially it will start with quarter, then it will become half, then it will become one, then it will become two. And as a stage comes when we shamelessly drink a lot and we lose our normal behavior. There are people around us who will tell us that, yeah, I cannot believe you will behave like this. Like I was working for one British company, in those days. So on one of the party days, they had called us to one star hotel. I would never go to such places, but because they had called, I had gone. I was not yet a monk at that time. I was a company going man. I saw big managers who had drunk liquor. They were practically running here and there. Like horses, they were running. They were wearing coat, suit, boot, tie, everything. They lost control completely. Because drinking actually drives a person mad, actually. And he can't be moderate. Initially, they may try to be moderate, but eventually they will lose that this thing. And then other people say that you slapped this person on that day in the party. You know, you caught the collar of this person. You may not even know, oh, really, I did it. So it makes us behave like an animal. It actually brings us down. Sometimes a man who drinks liquor and he leaves his wife and goes with another woman because he loses his balance. He becomes attached to another man's wife, and another man's wife sometimes shoots this person also sometimes. Such things happen like that. So if you want to lead a life of a perfect gentleman, you know, we don't put ourselves in deeper illusion. Correct, no? I would suggest that if somebody cannot give up meat and drink, they should reduce it, I would say. You know, for example, if somebody is eating meat every week, make it once a month. If you're eating once a month, make it once in 6 months. If it's once in 6 months, then eat once a year. If you're eating once a year, forget it, you know. Gradually like that, isn't it? We can gradually do that. Because you are not habituated to only vegetarian. In vegetarian food also, if you eat soya beans, channa, paneer, they have the same taste like meat. Prabhupada used to say that people who cannot give up meat, these are substitutes. So similarly, so when you take these things, one will at least have the psychological satisfaction of eating something equivalent. No, that will not go in vain. For that, good results will come separate. They don't, there is no like algebraic sum. See, for good things you will get good, for bad things you will get bad. Like that it comes. Yeah. See, at least a person begins to think that this is sin, I should not do that, I know it, and right now I am unable to give it up, but I will reduce it. So begin with reduction, so that don't keep doing the same manner. Then gradually it will go away. Is it all right? Yeah. Somebody, yes.
Prabhuji, my name is Sanjay. You spoke about the prodigal son from the Bible earlier. So I want to understand the concept of forgiveness. Is there any forgiveness for our bad deeds, for our bad karma?
Oh, definitely, yeah.
So how do we attain that? How do we work towards that? What is it? What is the concept of forgiveness?
Yeah. Actually, if we know that my behavior, say 5 years ago with somebody was inappropriate, due to which, you know, they closed doors for me. They became very upset with me. Now I am feeling repentance for the same. Now sometimes the trust is lost so badly that they are not even giving us an audience. But some people are not ready to meet personally, but they may not mind a letter if we send a letter. So we can send a letter of repentance, you know, we can pour down our heart and say that, you know, this is the way I behaved, and over the 5 years I underwent some training. Now I am much more better than before. I learned many lessons, and these are the mistakes I committed in my relation with you, and I am very sorry. Like one example I'll tell you. One boy wrote to me 10 years before he divorced his wife. Now they both actually went to the world and got learning through School of Hard Knocks, you know, outside. Now they both have come together again. They are considering to remarry and stay together again. So he asked me, Prabhuji, can we do that? I said, don't ask me, I will connect you to one family, Grihastha family. And I told that coming together is very easy again, because you have experienced bad things enough in the outside world. But again, you both have to come together with some commitments, you know, that we will not bring our old baggage again, all over again. So in this way, sometimes writing a letter of repentance and seeking forgiveness may melt their heart, it may soften their heart. Sometimes in case they are closing doors completely, we can pray to God. He is supremely forgiving. Actually, attaining the quality of repentance is the most important thing. If you have that, you are already forgiven. You know, if somebody is making a show of forgiveness to connect with somebody to get something else in return, that will be like a cooked up, made up forgiveness. It would be artificial. But if somebody is genuinely feeling, I made a mistake. Some children have mistreated their parents, some of the children. Later on when they grew up, they went abroad and, you know, they did many, they faced the world, you know, all the ups and downs of the world. They felt that, you know, I could have been different with them. They showered so much love on me and I didn't respond to them properly. Then some of them later on came back to India and then took the parents abroad, and in the last part of their life they took care of them very well. And that repentance, if it comes before death, then you will be completely relieved from the reactions, completely. Yeah, good, very important question, thank you.
But I'm not clear, I'm talking more of deeds, like Chacha was talking about me.
Yeah, yeah.
And you were talking about illicit relationship with other women.
Yeah.
And your wife.
Yes.
So when you commit such sins,
yeah.
What
happens when you commit such sins, they remain in your account. As a black account, that remains. And depending on your advancement in bhakti, Krishna says in the 18.66 verse, Aham Tvam Sarva Papebhyo Mokshayishyami. He says, I will cancel that black account to the degree you become serious in spiritual life. He says, for example, how he does that? Mamekam Sharanam Braja. He says, if you surrender to me by chanting Hare Krishna, reading Bhagavad Gita, now you have become enlightened. Now when you look back, you think, my Lord, you know, that was a very big blunder I did in that phase of my life. Now I know I'm not the body, I'm the soul. Now the soul is carrying good karma, bad karma, everything. Now that's already gone. That's already done now, and it is already on my back. It's behind me, it's coming behind me. So when we surrender to Krishna and chant the holy names, as we become purer and purer and purer, so and Krishna takes away the... Just like when you switch off the fan doesn't stop abruptly. It gradually stops. You know, before you end this body, you can finish off those karmas. It's possible. And it depends on how seriously you take to spiritual life. Yeah. Is that clear? Yeah. she is asking another question. Sometimes it's difficult for us to forgive others. So what you can do is, think about the mistakes you committed in your life and somebody else forgave you. Imagine if they didn't forgive you, how would you feel? You know, by thinking about that, you can empathically forgive others also. That's one thing. Second thing, you know, the other person, is he taking you for granted repeatedly, time and time again? If that is so, you can say that I have been forgiving 100 times. It doesn't make any sense. So then in that case, we can maintain distance. We have to become more formal with them, then the respect for you will increase. And they will also understand, oh, I have to be careful. Correct, no? But otherwise, we should always remember that, like I told you, forgiven are others, forgiven are those who forgive others. Yeah. Actually, why we forgive, I'll tell you. There are various reasons. One reason is you want to continue the relationship. Say you have another lady friend, another Mataji with whom you had a good relationship, but some small manmutav came, you know, some misunderstanding. So you both separated. Now if you forgive each other, then you can build bridges. If you don't forgive, you build walls around you. And we have to decide which one we want to do. You know, yeah. Yeah.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. So as you said, हम ह्यूमंस हैं, सो भगवान का भी रूप ह्यूमन ही होता है, बट किसी के कर्मों की वजह से समझो कोई काऊ बन जाता है, गाय बन जाता है, तो वो गाय किसकी भक्ति करे जिसे उसका कर्म बेटर हो, वो अगेन ह्यूमन का रूप ले अपना कर्म कैसा ठीक करे, दैट इज वन पार्ट. एंड पार्ट टू, जैसे भगवद गीता में शिशुपाल को चार हाथ एंड तीन आंख के साथ पैदा होता, आपने कहा ब्राह्मण्स जो होते हैं वो डीडीज का फॉर्म लेते हैं, तो उसका फॉर्म आउटकास्ट क्यों माना गया, एंड व्हाई डिड कृष्णा टेक बैक हिज फॉर्म?
किसका फॉर्म?
शिशुपाल का.
ओह राइट 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 राइट. एक्चुअली शिशुपाल वो भी भगवत धाम से, देखिए भगवान के धाम से कुछ लोग आते हैं, जय विजय भी आए थे, आप लोग शायद मालूम होगा आपको, है ना, जय विजय भी आए थे. इस तरह कुछ लोग भगवान के पार्षद हैं इस दुनिया में आते समय. देखो भगवान अपने पार्षदों को लेके आते हैं, जय विजय को. लेकिन जय विजय बने क्या बने मालूम है आपको? हिरण्याक्ष, हिरण्यकशिपु, उसके बाद शिशुपाल, दंडवक्र, और रावण और कुंभकर्ण. ये भगवान के ही पार्षद थे. लेकिन उनको असुर क्यों बनाया भगवान ने, मैं आपको बताऊंगा। कभी कभी एक पिताजी अपने बेटे के साथ झगड़ा करते हैं, छोटे बच्चे के साथ, देखा ना आपने ऐसे। तो भगवान को भी कभी स्टंट करने की इच्छा होता है भगवान के दाम में, उसको वीर रस बोलते हैं। वो वीर रस में भगवान को इच्छा होता है, लेकिन भगवान के भक्त कोई भी उनके साथ लड़ने के लिए तैयार नहीं। उधर ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा एक कमल को लेकर फेंकेंगे भगवान के ऊपर, उससे ज़्यादा नहीं कर पाएंगे वो, क्योंकि उनके अंदर भक्ति भावना है। तो भगवान क्या करते हैं, बोलते हैं कि तुम भूलोक में चले जाओ, मैं भी आ जाऊँगा, उधर तुमको असुर का शरीर दूंगा और हम दोनों लड़ाई करके आनंद लूटेंगे उसमें। इस तरह भगवान उनको भेजते हैं, उनको बुलकट बना देते हैं, उनके साथ लड़ाई करते हैं ऐसे। जैसे कभी कभी राजा लोग मल्ल जानते हैं आप लोग, मल्ल मीन्स पहलवान, पहलवान को लगाते हैं कुश्ती करने के लिए। तो उसे राजा को कुश्ती करके मजा आता है, रानियां भी ताली बजा रही हैं, हंस रही हैं, मंत्री लोग देख रहे हैं, लेकिन पहलवान जो है उनके दुश्मन नहीं है, राजा के वो दुश्मन नहीं है, उन्होंने नियुक्त किया है, वेतन भी देता है उनको। इस तरह भगवान भी अपने भक्तों को ही लेके आकर आसुरिक रूप देकर उनके साथ लड़ाई करके आनंद लूटते हैं, समझे आपने। हाँ, लेके जाते हैं उनको भी, नहीं उधर ही लेके जाते हैं उनको। लेकिन दुनिया के लोगों को अनेक सबक मिल जाता है, वो लेके जाते हैं। लेकिन दुनिया में लोग समझते हैं कि अभी रावण जैसे बनना नहीं चाहिए, उनका गलत कुकर्म किया उन्होंने, हम ऐसा नहीं करना, सब समझ जाते हैं लोग। लोगों को भी सीख मिल जाता है, भगवान का आनंद भी प्राप्त हो जा रहा है उनको भी, दोनों करेक्ट है ना। या व्हाट इज द पार्ट वन यू आस्क्ड,
अगर कोई कर्म की वजह से गाय बन जाता है, गाय किसकी भक्ति करे जिससे उसका कर्म फल।
एक्चुअली गाय को कुत्ते को उनको भक्ति नहीं करना है, उनको दे आर वर्किंग ऑफ देयर कर्मा, बट डिफॉल्ट दे विल कम टू ह्यूमन बॉडी। देखिए अगर मानव शरीर में किसी के पास चार पांच गलत इच्छाएं थे जानवरी प्रवृत्ति की, जैसे मैंने बताया ये somebody is a lusty रोग, ही becomes a dog, somebody is all the time playing in water surfing, he'll become a fish, ऐसे चार पांच इच्छाएं उनमें, तो वो पांच शरीर लेते हैं ऐसे टक 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 टक, वो होने के बाद बाई डिफॉल्ट आ जाते हैं मनुष्य शरीर में। सिर्फ कर्म करते हैं मनुष्य शरीर में, बाकी अभी देवता के शरीर में भी नया कर्म नहीं होता है। देवता का मतलब पुण्य, वो लोग काउंट डाउन कर रहे हैं 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, वो होने के बाद मनुष्य शरीर में आ जाएंगे। अब ये लोग भी -5, -4, -3, -1 आ जाएंगे वापस, लेकिन मनुष्य शरीर में ही नया कर्म करते हैं हम लोग। इसलिए सावधानी से हमें जीवन जीना चाहिए मनुष्य जीवन में। हाँ करेक्ट, हाँ वो कर्म नहीं है, वो भक्ति सुकृति है। एक्चुअली भक्ति सुकृति जिनके अकाउंट में, वो जानवर के उनमें कौन जाएंगे, वो नहीं जाएंगे, वो तो मनुष्य जन्म ही बार बार लेते रहेंगे। अभी 40 से 60 हो गया, 60 से 90 हो गया, 100% प्योरीफाई हो गया तो निकल जाएंगे, भगवद्धाम लौट जाएंगे, ठीक है ना। या सो इट्स 8:40, आई हैव अ बॉस्टन कॉल टुमारो एट 3 o'clock, 3 a.m. आई हैव टू रश बैक। वी कैन कंक्लूड विद दिस, थैंक यू। इट विल बी अवेलेबल, या एक्चुअली दिस विल बी अपलोडेड इन माई यूट्यूब चैनल ओनली, एंड द लिंक विच इज गिवन it will be available, yeah. Mukundhari Prabhu?
Yeah. Thank you so much, Prabhuji. I'm sure sab
very brilliant question, sir, today.
Sab log enlighten ho gaye, aap seriously, ye sabse, I'm sure ye sabko bahut bahut acha laga ye service aapka. I can't thank you and all the devotees enough.
So these devotees are all living in Hyderabad or different places?
I'm
from Calcutta. Calcutta. Oh, in Calcutta you came for this occasion, okay. Okay. Yoga. He has a business in Calcutta there. Calcutta, there is one new temple coming up near the airport. You know, it's going to, big temple is going to come there.
They are developing Mayapur also.
Mayapur also, yeah, correct. Correct. Yeah? Mumbai, okay. Which place in Mumbai?
I'm from Bandra, but I'm from Delhi.